Oh, we did it, boys. We did it. All right. While we are waiting, I am going to grab a drink. I will be right back. And I'm going to go to the toilet. Don't go anywhere, chat. I'm going to be right back. Be right back.
Arriving. I'm Lauren Moore. I'm here with Tim Liu, and we will be your Crunchyroll orange carpet hosts this evening.
We cannot wait for you to see what's planned for tonight. It's the 8th Annual Anime Awards, where millions of you voted to fight for what you love to help honor the best of the best in anime. It has all led to this.
There is so much excitement in the air right now, and we don't want you to miss a single moment. So we have
Let's go!
We'll be here talking live with your favorite creators and stars like Shingo 2, Aquarius.
Oh yeah, I should probably do the thing.
So many more.
By the way, this stream, this portion of the stream is now sponsored by Crunchyroll. You can click that link in the pinned chat right now, or if you click, or if you're watching on the VOD, you can click that link in the description to
what is the link there? Sally Amaki and John Kabira will take the stage.
Well, okay, there we go. Okay. You can click the link in the pinned chat to get your own Crunchyroll account. Right?
I've even seen podcasts preparing for their live coverage.
Scuffed. I just realized they didn't give me talking points. So I was like, shit, what do I say? What do I say? It's a fucking ad read, guys. You know what Crunchyroll is. You can watch anime on Crunchyroll. Did you know that a lot of these anime that is going to be on the Anime Awards right now is streaming live on Crunchyroll. Click that link in the chat to get your own Crunchyroll account. And,
Let's introduce maybe we can do this more. Very important people. We are here with longtime.
Please, I want to keep a good relationship with Crunchyroll so I can do more anime watch streams, man.
As well as content creator, cosplayer, and huge anime fan, Lena Lemon. Hello. And they are going to be joining us for the rest of the pre-show.
Is it too quiet?
All right, let me turn off. Welcome to the Anime Awards, you two.
My goodness, first time. This is exciting. The glamour, the glitz. Feels like a Hollywood production.
Pretty so excited to be here.
Pretty exciting. So I'm not sure if you both actually know this, but we will be announcing winners for
stream 20 too quiet.
Fan favorite awards.
Is this still too quiet?
For the live stream viewers.
Right. 20 in an hour is
that's
a
like
lot.
What?
It's a lot.
Three,
you gotta get going.
One every 3 minutes.
And that's before maps. Even the main show. There's still a main award show happening.
Oh my goodness.
All right. So is there an award that you're most excited for?
Right, Lena, let me adjust the volume on my speaker so it doesn't bleed through quickly.
For no particular reason. Why do you ask that, Laura?
No shade.
Things I might know.
Well, if I had to choose one, it'll probably be
now it's
the
too
best
loud.
Supporting character for no particular reason.
No
at
particular
all.
Reason. What about you?
All right, that was about right.
You know, I'm actually looking forward to the best film because I think there's so many cool films that came out in 2023. I know a lot of the TV series get most of the attention, but there's some pretty cool anime films out there. I mean, you know, Slam Dunk, Suzume, just saying, you know.
Yeah, out of all of the categories that's got
Night by some of your favorite
that I voted on. I am sad that I didn't watch more anime films. Pretty much the only anime film I watched was Suzume. That was pretty much it.
Lauren, it is. I am joined by anime TikToker and pro gamer, Vinny Hacker.
Pro gamer! It is no Let's go!
That anime holds a special place in your heart. Could you tell us a little bit about that?
Damn. Of course. I'm a relevant man. I'm just an anime YouTuber.
Dragon Ball at that time. So I'm a huge action fan. Love seeing those big fights and I'm
Model,
excited
pro
to
gamer,
see
entrepreneur, and voiceover
Ooh, yes,
and
you
film
also,
actor.
I found out that you have a huge alt account.
Guys, I'm irrelevant now. I would never get invited to these awards anymore in person because I am just I'm just a poor anime YouTuber now. What's the TikTok? How do you do a TikTok?
Well, I was super excited, obviously. You know, I've never had an opportunity like this before. So when I got the news, you know, I was
Genshin streamer.
And I immediately jumped out of my seat and hopped on
but
the
But of course, guys, it wouldn't be an anime awards watch party without some beer. So I'm going to have a chill beer while we watch these awards together.
At the top of my lungs. I screamed as loud as I could.
You spend too much money on gacha, you're a pro gamer. I think that's the opposite of a pro gamer. I shouldn't be spending money to game. I should be getting money while gaming.
If someone needs an anime recommendation, what immediately comes into your mind?
Oh, here we go.
I'd have to say Jujutsu Kaisen.
You are my special.
All right, Vinny, it is time
you know,
to present
like,
first
in terms of introducing any anime to anyone, I'd say Jujutsu Kaisen is a good blind pick. I'd say Attack on Titan is a stronger blind pick, though.
They transport us to awe-inspiring worlds of heroes battling villains, life-threatening situations, and characters overcoming incredible odds. Here are your nominees for Best Action.
Jujutsu Kaisen's gonna win this. Attack on Titan, there ain't no way Jujutsu Kaisen isn't going to win this, man.
Bleach, Thousand Year Blood War, The Separation, Studio Pierrot. Chainsaw Man, MAPPA. Demon Slayer, Kimetsu no Yaiba, Swordsmith Village Arc, UFO Table. Jujutsu Kaisen Season 2, MAPPA. One Piece, Toei Animation.
I think Jujutsu Kaisen has an inherent... Oh wait, we're awarding it right now?
Jujutsu Kaisen
of
Season 2!
Of course!
Let's go! You are my special.
It would have been the biggest plot twist so of all time if, if it didn't win, but I will say it is deserved.
By actress, advocate, and major anime fan, Liza Soberano. Welcome to the Anime Awards. Thank you so much for being here.
I'm so happy to be here. Thank you.
We're happy to have you. So how does it feel to be at the Anime Awards?
Nah, I'd sweep, yeah. All right, how many awards do you think Jujutsu Kaisen is going
to
win today?
Celebrating like such a huge like phenomenon going out through the world, and I'm just excited to like see all these very inspirational people and see like my favorite voice actors in person. So I'm just excited.
Too much.
Overall. Love it. Well, we're happy to have you here.
Thank you.
Musical artists too. It's going to be crazy. Mm-hmm. So I know that you're no stranger to the world of animation from a professional standpoint, but could you tell us a little bit about your personal love and your journey through anime?
So I first got introduced to anime when I was very young, I believe like 4 or 5, through Yu-Gi-Oh! And my brother and I were huge fans of the show, and also like we loved collecting the cards.
Yeah.
As I got older, I got into
Where's Kevin? Kevin's not here this year, unfortunately.
Rosario Vampire, some of the classics. Okay. And then later on in my career, I was given the opportunity to be the voice of Alexandra Trece in the first Filipino animated series called Trece.
Yes.
That was kind of my journey. It was a full
circle
moment.
She was in Trece? Okay.
I'm here, and I'm so happy to be here, and just so excited for the
Sea Gang? Sea Gang.
Okay, so you've definitely got a very long history with anime. What is an anime that you would suggest to someone who's maybe just starting out?
I actually asked my little brother this because I told him that I want to get back into anime, like all the newer ones, because it's been a while since I've caught up on my anime. But I think One Piece.
I feel that. Hi, Joey. How are you doing?
That was the most PR.
I haven't watched anime in a while, guys. But I've been meaning to catch up, guys.
I know that you've got a busy night ahead. Please enjoy the show and
Thank you so much.
It's been a pleasure.
We'll see you right over there. Yeah.
Thank you.
Enjoy. And thank you all for joining us. So we have even more celebrity anime fans here this evening. Let's check in with one of our pre-show award presenters.
Ooh.
Here's rapper and performing artist Shay Lingo.
Yo, it's your boy Shay Lingo, backstage at the Anime Awards. Just got done with a pre-show rehearsal.
I unfortunately do not know this gentleman, but I hear a British accent.
Stay tuned in.
That is not an accent I expected to hear in the Anime Awards, man.
That's right, Tim. We're about to reveal another fan favorite award category, voice acting. And there are so many languages to celebrate tonight. We'll be revealing winners
British,
for
it?
Best
it's
Voice
British.
Artist Performance for Japanese, Arabic, Portuguese, French, and so many more.
Who do you guys think is going to win? Who did you vote for? Comment.
I honestly can't
Drop
remember
those
who I voted for.
In the chat, and let's go straight to our first winner announcement.
I honestly can't remember who I voted for.
Best voice artist performance.
I don't think I did vote on the dub because I didn't watch many dubs.
Chainsaw Man, MAPPA. Best voice artist performance, Arabic. Talib al-Refai, Senku Ishigami, Dr. Stone, TMS.
Yo, where's my role, man? Why wasn't I nominated?
Tsuguru Geto, Jujutsu Kaisen Season 2, MAPPA.
Congratulations to our first winners of the night.
So my one line in Mashal. Where was that representation, man?
Massive production. But if you've ever wondered what it's like to be a front
Where's my boy Rhodes Emus at, man?
Thought we'd like to share a little slice of what that's like.
Well, let's take a look behind the scenes at Tim and Lauren's Anime Awards journey.
Yeah.
Ooh. Man, Tim's been working at Crunchyroll forever. Hour number two, you're right. Hour number two is the real goated role, man. All right. Yo, this must be the best job. You just get to travel to Japan and just do fun stuff. And you're like, yeah, I'm on company. I'm doing company expense, man. Here's the thing. Just go to Japan, eat a bunch of food, and Hachiko. Get this TikTok sheet out of my face. We have reached an age where we can now stream vertical video.
Crunchyroll Anime Awards to
and it'd be the norm,
from
man.
Tokyo this year, a city that's had such
Tim's the go. I know. I don't think I've ever met Tim personally. Every time I've gone to like a Crunchyroll event, I don't think I've had the chance to meet him. Well, I would definitely like to.
Give a little quick shout out to all the studios that I was able to visit in Tokyo. There's so many studios, like Studio Orange is here.
You went and visited them?
Yeah, with studios.
This is how to use your company money, cough gunk.
I'm so jealous.
Get a little studios. All right,
Look,
to talk to an
we did,
legend.
Everything's all good. Champion. It was a funny bit for the episode. Cry. We paid
you know
Joey back afterwards. We
doesn't?
Chill.
Let's be real.
Don't worry, guys. We chill. We are chill.
So good. If you have not
it was, I, we thought
champion.
It would be worth it for Joey's reaction,
you
and it
should.
Totally was. It was
100%. What are you doing?
One of like my funniest moments that I've recorded on Trash Taste.
No,
it was so worth
it. You need
to
put
it
on a widescreen and watch. You need to watch
two.
Samurai Champloo, all right? Listen.
Hell yeah, the goat!
Oh, are you going to start?
I should just start doing the whole song, honestly. Yeah.
Special performance by Tim? I didn't know I was signing up for this.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so I just got word that Shingo2 is still taking some photos.
Oh, okay.
So I wanted to talk to you guys about what it's like being in here in Tokyo right now, because this is honestly amazing. I'm sure you guys have all.
Yeah, what's it like being in Tokyo? I would have no idea. I have no idea. What's it like being all the way in Tokyo? Oh, my God. I can't even imagine.
Korean director Bong Joon-ho.
There's a particular one.
Yeah,
you
yeah,
talking
no,
about
yeah,
her.
Yeah,
she
walked
right,
right, right, right, right, walk right back
and
like,
did the
director
Bong Joon-ho. And are you jealous?
Where is
you
that?
Watch
it
again.
Right behind
he
us.
Walked right back and did like a.
And did the biggest smile. And
wait,
are
why
you
is
jealous?
The...
Because you weren't here. It was.
Oh, it's because YouTube was planked.
Do one of those. Wow, that was a great
impression.
Wait, how long is it?
I'm all excited to see tonight.
Oh, how long was it echoing for? I hope it wasn't that long.
And Lisa fan, but Yoasobi's obviously performing, which is gonna be so good. Right. It's gonna be so good. All right, I'm gonna leave you guys alone for a little bit. I'll let you keep chatting.
All right. So, let's bring on to the stage
Do we have Shingo? Shingo O2 on the stage?
No,
we're going straight to the awards. So, welcome to the Anime Awards. We're gonna get
hell yeah.
And we're gonna really get into it, and we're just gonna get into the Anime Awards. And I want you guys to know that Battle Cry will be performing later on the main show.
So yo, wait, Battle Cry is performing? Yo, that's fucking hype, man.
Did you?
Amazing.
Oh, I wasn't there.
Yo,
for that,
fuck
you know
yeah.
That just makes me even more excited.
Mm-hmm. All right, so let's find out.
Stolen, look, this I've been on the other side of this camera before. Sometimes you just gotta need. Sometimes you just need to stall, man. It's a live show.
We have Ilona Garcia with us tonight on the orange carpet. How does it feel to be here at the Anime Awards?
I'm super grateful. I mean, this is my first time in Japan, and this is my first time at Anime Awards, and I'm just. Goosebumps.
I don't know this person either, but I also hear another.
Thank you.
You have said that anime has played a huge.
Is she Filipino? Why does she have a slight British accent tinge?
The first few moments that popped up at the top of my head was one time back in 2016. I was
damn Filipinos really getting some representation,
eh? On the way,
you guys just keep winning. When's the Thai representation?
And my siblings.
That's Aussie. Oh, okay.
Studio Ghibli movies, Spirited Away, and Howl's Moving Castle.
That's pretty perfect.
That's not Aussie. That's way too. That's way too polite to be Aussie.
Taught me to take a pause.
I'm gonna say it. Really probably is Aussie, but this is the most polite Aussie accent I've ever heard, man.
13 and life was just go, 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 go. So that 3 hours was like, it was 6 hours.
Yeah,
those 6 hours were worth it. I was like,
yeah. Those are pretty good. Those are pretty good movies to do that.
Sometimes we polite. All right, just
yeah. Well, I think it's
you have one day over the year when you're polite.
What do you think? You want to help us out?
I do.
All right, let's do it.
All right, so these are the characters who make our hearts melt. Sometimes funny, sometimes adorable, but always, always, always worth protecting. Here are the nominees for Must Protect at All Costs character.
Yeah, it's going to be Anya, right? Surely Anya's going to win this one.
Must Protect at All Costs character.
I want Miri to win as a good representation for like a real kid.
Bocchi,
but she's not going to win.
The treasure chest of courage with studio.
If Bocchi wins, I'm actually going to laugh
the
as well.
Rock, Cloverworks. Miryu Nosaki, Buddy Daddy's PA Works. Pochita, Chainsaw Man, MAPPA.
I actually don't know who's going to win.
Gundam, the Witch from Mercury.
I think it's going to be Anya. It's going to be Anya, right?
And the award goes to... Anya Forger, Spy Family.
Yep. Yep. Of course.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. Oh, I got it.
I know. And thank you for helping me out, Ilona. It's been a pleasure.
Deserved, yeah. I mean, any one of those nominations could have won it, and it would have been deserved, I think. Very sure.
Congratulations.
Every time I hang out with Didus now, Lord, he just goes off on Anya every time, and he's just like,
I know.
So Didus calls Anya a minion, and ever since he referred to Anya as a minion, I can't unsee that. It's like, bro, she's just a minion, bro. She's just a fucking minion.
The main event will be kicking off soon.
Yes, we're of course Boji robbed. I mean, Boji got here, Boji like at the end of the show did not need any protecting. That's all I will say,
to
man.
Find out who the winners are for more awards like Best Anime Film and one of my favorites, Anime of the Year.
So many of your favorite nominees and stars are all arriving for the ceremony, and I'm pretty excited because our team just told us Lisa and Yeji are making their way to the orange carpet. Plus, we'll have more coming up with Emiru, Porter Robinson, DeMarcus Lawrence, Mercedes Coronado, and more.
That's right. There's so much more to come, and you do not want to miss this. So make sure you keep watching. Also, have you ever wondered what it's like to be on the award show carpet with all the lights flashing? Did you?
No.
You guys ever
wanted
this lovely orange carpet? Well, Lauren and I did earlier, and we thought we'd give you a little sneak peek what it's like to walk the orange carpet. Let's check it out. All right, and then I will take a look at the newest hero, Atomic Samurai, for the fan favorite character that just released in the game One Punch Man World. The
wait, what?
Action game based on the One Punch Man anime.
Did we just get King Crimson there?
We're about to show you. So come on.
Did we just get King Crimson IRL? We just like, wait, okay. And that was it.
Yeah, Anime Awards.
Damn, okay, that was...
So I don't know if you know, but there were 34 million votes for the Anime Awards this year.
34 million. That's you guys.
Yeah, that's a lot of weeps. That's a lot of weeps.
Isn't that crazy?
All
that
right, well,
wild.
I know I just sent him to go get set up with another presenter. Let's go check in with him and see what they're talking about.
He died, Lamau.
Hey everyone, I'm joined by singer, DJ, and huge anime fan. Give it up for Yeji!
Hey Tim, thanks for having me.
안녕하세요. 안녕하세요. 반갑습니다. 네, of course, and thank you so much for stopping by. You've talked a lot about the impact anime has had on your life, and we've seen it in your work as well. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, I think my earliest memory of anime was from childhood when I lived in a neighborhood where no one else looked like me. So anime was my day-to-day. It was my
she just like me for real.
It was my representation. It was really realer than real life for me.
I think a lot of anime fans.
Oh, she just like me for real.
I hope it was.
I also grew.
I know.
Man, so this is being Asian in Brighton, which is now a really progressive city. Yo, that shit hit different, man.
No doubt it's Nichijou.
You heard it, Nichijou. Yes.
She okay. She got good taste, right, man. Yeji, she got good taste.
Are you ready to announce the next award?
Ooh, I am.
Let's go.
While countless new anime are created each year, we're going to take a moment to honor new series and spin-offs that stand out. These shows are instant classics that are unique, keeping us all transfixed and passionately awaiting season 2. Here are the nominees for Best New Series.
Oh, we're doing Best New Series.
Best New Series.
Bocchi the Wild. Oh, this is so hard. Bocchi.
Mappa. Heavenly Delusion. Production
I want Bocchi to win. I
Hell's
think...
Paradise, Jigoku Raku.
Shit, I don't know what's... What do you think is going to win? I think is going to win? Probably...
Zom 100, Bucket List of the Dead, Bug Films.
I think Chainsaw Man's going to win.
The winner for Best New Series is...
But I want Bocchi.
Chainsaw!
Okay. Yes, all right. We did it.
Yeji, enjoy the rest of the night. Time it up. Thank you so much for stopping by. And Lena.
Are we like 100% so far in our predictions? In our predictions?
Thanks, Tim, we're here watching.
Drink, I'll drink every time I get a prediction wrong.
Wait to hear the winner for the last category.
Deserved, yeah. Chainsaw Man was very, very good.
That was such a strong category this year.
There were some very, very strong contenders in Best New Anime.
Heavenly Delusion, Oshinoko's on 100, Hell's Paradise.
I watched all of them personally.
It was a tough one.
She didn't say Bocchi, she said every nomination but Bocchi.
I do not know how voting works for these categories. Like I mentioned earlier,
maybe Bocchi's gonna win one single award, right? maybe Bocchi's gonna win one single award. She did say Bocchi, all right. My bad. My ears are broken.
Around the world.
You guys are what makes this.
We're back here on the orange carpet, and I've got another guest to help me announce
a hard
some
cut,
more
man.
Special category winners. Give it up for fashion model, drag entertainer, DJ, winner of RuPaul's Drag Race Season 10, music video star, overall icon, and of course, an anime fan. Give it up for Aquaria!
Woo! Hello, Tim!
Hello, a pleasure. First of all, we know you created some top-tier anime looks. Tell us about your look tonight.
Oh my goodness, tonight I wanted to give you glamour for the Crunchyroll orange carpet.
The diamonds.
I kind of feel like if Hatsune Miku
hey man,
went
live,
to the Met
it's live
Gala,
production, I've
this
been
is
there.
Kind of what I feel like
if it's,
she would
if it's not like a little bit scuffed, then it's not a true
right,
live production,
Aquaria.
Man.
Oh, you're a big anime fan, actually. So
huge.
Could you share some of your faves and what do you love about them?
Oh, goodness. I love Cowboy Bebop. Ooh. I love Evangelion. And I love them because they just transport me to a whole nother world. And mm-hmm. sometimes this world's feeling so
JoJo?
Funny
yeah.
you got to get somewhere else.
If they said JoJo, I would not be surprised at all.
Are you ready to announce the next category and winner?
Duh.
Let's do it.
So, the mastery of building and relieving tension in these shows set fans on the edge of their seats, feeling all their feelings and compelling us to invest deeply into the characters and stories. Here are your nominees for Best Drama.
Ooh, this one's gonna be hard.
Best Drama. Attack on Titan Final Season.
Oh
final
no, it's Vinland Saga.
Special
it's Vinland Saga is gonna win this one, and Vinland Saga.
this
one's not gonna be hard. It's gonna be
My
Vinland
Happy
Saga.
Marriage, Kinema Citrus. Oshinoko, Dogakoro.
I'm nah. You're saying Attack on Titan for
Vinland
the popularity
saga,
vote? Nah,
two?
Vinland Saga is too OP. Vinland, I'm predicting it. If I lose, I drink.
And
Vinland Saga is going to win.
Best drama is. Attack on Titan final season.
Congratulations, Attack on Titan final season, the final chapter, special.
I had hope. I had hope.
Oh, yes.
Oh, well, great. We'll see you again shortly.
Right, I'll finish this drink, man.
But right now, let's find out some more winners for Best Voice Artist Performance.
No. No.
Best Voice Artist Performance.
Oh.
Leo Rabello.
You have no enemies? Maybe I do. Maybe I do. I mean, I thought that Vinland Best Saga had enough Joel of Jimenez, an Denji, impact Chainsaw to Man. Overpower the popularity of Attack on Titan. But I mean, Attack on Titan isn't bad by any means. Vinland Saga is just that OP, man.
Back to back. So let's check in with what you all at home have been saying on social. You guys have been talking about your predictions, and we are seeing that a lot of you are very certain that the best continuing series category is the one that you have, predicted correctly. So we will have to see. But we do want to keep the conversation going, so keep posting, keep chatting.
Were your predictions correct? Yes. Yes, my predictions haven't gone any wrong yet. I called it. I said Attack on Titan is going to be best drama. I fucking called it. I absolutely called it.
We will be posting on Instagram and X using hashtag Anime Awards. Join the discussions and let us know what you're thinking. Lena, what about you? How are you feeling right now?
Oh my God, I just can't believe we live in a time where we are celebrating anime.
We live in a society.
I know. Look at how you guys are probably seeing everyone just walk behind us, all the huge guests, the cameras. Like, it is just insane. It is incredible.
It's a lot. Did you have any idea that the show would be this big?
Honestly, I did not think it would be like to this scale.
How many of you guys are in America right now?
I mean, I feel like it's just really
because this is like, I think the biggest show they've put on, and I think it's a shame that it's not good for like any Americans that would be watching it.
Celebrating.
Yo, you guys are still up?
Oh, that's so cool.
4:30 a.m. God damn, man. God damn.
And nominee Shingo Chu, if you're just joining us, it's been a great show so far.
Yo, hope you're not messing up your sleep patterns.
Stuff that we're doing. So this carpet has been very busy. There's a ton of press behind us. There's flash bulbs going off. We're going to see even more nominees, celebs, and so much more.
Hi, Rosebuds. I was so inspired after learning I was presenting the award for Best Fantasy. So we're doing a cute little photo shoot. What do you think? Ooh. Imagination, creativity, and a bit of magic. These elements are essential when creating worlds for viewers to experience. Anime doesn't just take us there. It crafts deep original universes full of.
Yo, what's she doing here? We know weebs don't have drip. We know weebs don't have drip.
Ideas that were
Please teach us.
Of. Your nominees for Best Fantasy are
Best Fantasy. Demon Slayer Kimetsu no Yaiba's Swordsmith Village Arc.
It's gonna be Demon Slayer, guys. It's gonna be Demon Slayer.
Mappa, Mastle, Magic and Muscles, A1
Joey?
Pictures.
Joey has transcended weed. He needed to stop watching anime for him to get good drip, man.
Studio Bind Co. Limited.
I mean, I would like Mushoku Tensei to win. I know it's not. Studio.
The Ancient Magus Bride, Season 2, Studio Kafka.
And the winner is...
All right, drum roll in the chat, everybody.
You can't leave me like that.
The winner is Demon Slayer Kimetsu no Yaiba Swordsmith Village.
What did I say, guys? What did I say? What did I say? What did I say, guys? What did I say? No drink for me. No drink for me. What did I say?
Another really stacked category this year.
No.
We had nominees, like, especially for a fantasy category, we had some very action-oriented nominees. We also had very emotional nominees.
Once again, Demon Slayer taking the best fantasy, man. Once again.
They're all under fantasy, but they all have their own little flair.
Next year, I have hope. Because next year, we got Mushoku Tensei 2, we got Frieren, we got Delicious and Dungeon. Next year, I have hope that someone else can take the best fantasy genre.
And more. We'll be right back, so stay with us for the rest of the 2024 Crunchyroll Anime Awards pre-show.
To be fair, I'm a lot less salty this year compared to last year, because last year Because this year, I think, in terms of fantasy, the nominations were not as strong.
We're here on the Anime Awards, not as strong as last year.
This year, I'm like, okay, I don't mind too much.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Next year, though. Next year is when the heavy hitters come, man. Next year is when the heavy hitters come.
Can you please tell us some of your favorites? We got to know the list.
Parasite.
Okay.
Definitely.
Okay.
Oh, fuck
Blue
yeah.
Blue Lock's great. Solo Leveling is fantastic.
Of course.
Obviously, Jujutsu Kaisen. Mm-hmm. What else? Bakano.
This is a good
yeah,
yo, he's just said Bakano. Let's go.
Bakano, 91 Days.
All right.
Okay. You get, I,
you,
I can you get see, that idea.
All right. He watches anime, bro.
Absolutely. I knew I could
rely on my fellow Brit, man.
And I have one question that I gotta ask. You just mentioned Parasite. My co-host, Tim, made me promise that I would ask you this.
Okay.
If you had to be infected with a parasite in one part of your body, which part of your body would you choose?
Shout out to Tim
for the question.
Every man is thinking it right now.
I can already use that. So probably my left hand.
It's a sensible choice.
Yeah, trying
sensible
to choice. Get my ambidextrous on. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
definitely.
Perfect.
Like the way well, the way he reacted, every guy on earth was just like.
For everyone watching at home,
I know. I'm thinking it, but I'm not gonna say it.
Ending sequences paired together with design and music to wrap an unforgettable bow at the end of each episode. However,
Oshinoko is gonna win this one.
Can become just as iconic to a fandom as the anime itself. Here are your nominees.
Best
he's smiling,
sequence.
Yo. The way he smiles, man. You know.
Soshi Sakiyama, Jujutsu Kaisen.
Oh, actually, Jujutsu Kaisen might win this one.
Color Yama, Spy Family Season 1.
The problem
one,
with Chainsaw
14,
Man is that he had so Gale many Cloverworks. Openings that I don't think it's going to win.
Huey, Zom 100 Bucket List of the Dead, Bug Film.
I know if it was Japan, it would be Oshinoko.
200 million centimeter long blades, Maximum the Hormone, Chainsaw Man.
I think Oshinoko is going to win.
Kogare, Mire and Man with a Mission, Demon Slayer Kimetsu no Yaiba.
I feel like with how Mephisto, big of an impact, Queen how big of a meme
Oshinoko,
that.
Doga Kobo.
How big of a meme? Hey, honey.
And your winner for best ending sequence is Akari, Soshi Sakiyama. Jujutsu Kaisen Season 2.
Okay, it is Jujutsu Kaisen
death.
Again.
Oh my God.
It's going to be a sweep.
This
it's going to be a sweep. If Mephisto, with how
so
big
much.
Of a meme that was, well. Couldn't overpower Jujutsu Kaisen, yo, it's going
well,
to be a sweep.
Before we head out, is there anything else you're excited to see next?
Definitely Anime of the Year.
Anime of the Year.
Thanks, Shay and Lauren. Shay is a great artist and a massive anime fan, and I'm so grateful to have him stop by.
Okay, we are not far out from the main show. Do you all want a sneak peek of what the ballroom looks like?
Yes.
Well, he does.
All right.
Well, our teams grabbed some footage during show prep to share with everyone, so let's check it out.
Sorry, guys. I have some things I need to fix quickly. Okay.
How do I do this? Ballroom looks amazing.
Incredible. Amazing. Like the graphics, the everything, oh my gosh.
The package looks amazing. Honestly, it looks great on the video, but let me tell you, if you actually walk in there,
in
the
person,
chandeliers,
oh my.
The lights, the glamour. But yeah, such a huge show, and I just want to give a shout out to everybody that worked on it because it's months of planning and work.
Hold on, guys. I just got a message that I need to do some things.
So many details from the minute nominees stepped through the door, when they walked on stage, the orange carpet, they got to take a break to the thing, they got to put the makeup, they got to get them ready. Like,
oh, wow, you know your thing.
Plus, millions and millions of fans voting to fight for what they love and honor their faith. So thank you, fans, for voting. Yeah.
All right, let's check back in with Lauren, who's sharing what you all are talking about on social.
Thanks, you two. So earlier this week, we asked you all to let us know where you were watching from tonight. We wanted you to rep your city, rep your country. So we're checking in from all over the globe. We've got people watching from Mexico, I saw Kenya, Germany, Malaysia. We've got even folks watching from the Caribbean. That's my home region. Shout out to the Cayman Islands. Love seeing you all tuning in from everywhere. All right, Timelina, over to you.
Love seeing where everybody's from. Keep letting us know too. Keep chatting. Where are you guys from? Where are y'all from? Where are you from, Lena?
Anyone from Toronto in chat? Any Torontonians out there?
Any South Korea, Yosu? Seoul?
Drop it in chat, guys. I want to see it.
Australia, Sydney, Australia. Any Sydney Australians?
Why did you just name like three?
I grew up in all Mexico City.
Mexico stop Diete. Adding, Mexico stop Diete. Adding.
Eh, que paso, amigos?
All right, guys. It is time for another special category winner reveal. And we've brought in the help of a very special guest to announce it for us.
That's done.
Hello, this is Emmer from the set of Steak and Eggs, and it's time for another award. A main character is the face of their series, but it's not just their characteristics or personalities that make us love them.
Emmer?
It's also their well-thought-out stories
what?
And the journeys that
Wait,
they take
what?
Us on.
Wait, what? What the hell did I miss?
Here are the nominees for Best Main Character.
Best Main Character. Denji.
Ooh.
Chainsaw Man. Mappa.
Eren Jaeger is going to win this one, though. Thorfinn should win this one, but Eren Jaeger is going to win this one.
Uchi the Rock, Cloverworks. Monkey D. Luffy, One Piece, Toei Animation. Shigeo Kageyama, Mob Psycho 103, Bones. Thorfinn, Villain Saga Season 2, Mappa.
All right, and your winner is, drum roll please.
Monkey D. Luffy from One Piece.
Wait, Monkey D. Oh, shit. Okay, okay.
Oh, my goodness. I know. So he had a great year this year, you know, Gear 5, the whole...
I'll take the L on that. I'll take the L on that.
Oh, my God. Lots going on.
And so now we also... I just want to hype up the main event for the main show, Anime of the Year. Are you excited?
Am I excited? I am so excited. Why are you like this?
I don't know. So here's some of the people who just want to refresh you guys. So there's Chainsaw Man, Oshinoko, Jujutsu Kaisen Season 2, Bochi the Rock, Demon Slayer, Kimetsu Oshinoko, Swordsmith Village, or Finland Saga Season 2.
That is a mouthful.
God,
and that is a stacked lineup of anime. Whew. I cannot wait until we finally find out the winner. But before that, we've got another celebrity guest here to chat with us.
Oh, wow. Ooh. We have none other than Iman Vellani from the Miss Marvel series with us. Please welcome to the Anime Awards, Iman!
Hi!
Hello, how are you guys?
You look beautiful.
I love it when people say you look amazing and they themselves already look amazing. I'm like,
I'm just like fishing for the compliment, please.
Oh, smart.
Wait, before we go, I see a little nail situation.
Oh my.
You guys can't see, but there's Ghibli on her nails.
Do you want to go right up to the camera and show the Ghibli nails? Yeah, get right in there.
Right in there.
Yeah, you see it?
You guys see that?
That is beautiful. That is beautiful.
Looks amazing.
Okay.
So, how does it feel here to be here at the Anime Awards?
I kind of feel like an imposter. I'm like, have I seen enough? Do I know enough people?
No,
honestly here to learn. I am a new anime fan, but I'm super obsessed now. Like, people are recommending me stuff. I'm watching it. I'm invested. So, yeah.
The world is your oyster right now when you're a new anime fan, right?
Yeah.
There's just so much out there that you can start watching.
That was
not intentional. Oh, my God. All right. Iman, how would you describe your relationship with anime?
She's really green right now. But I think there's potential there.
Yeah.
I think we get along very well.
You see marriage potentials either?
Totally. Ooh. I think this is a long-term relationship.
Oh, it's not a fling? It's
no.
Not a
no.
We
I'm
love
not
to
dropping
hear that.
It after this. It's not
that.
A facade.
Oh,
yeah.
So I have to ask this very hard question. It's going to be a hard-hitting question. What is the one anime everyone should go watch if they haven't seen it yet?
I mean, my first anime was Attack on Titan. So if you haven't seen that, what are you doing? Because even I've seen it. Yeah.
So, some of you watching at home also sent in questions for Iman through the Anime Awards hashtag, and we've got these questions right here. You want to go first, Lena?
All right.
Sorry, guys. I'm just trying to sort something out.
Luffy.
Luffy.
Or right now I just started Bocchi the Rock.
Oh.
Do you relate to Bocchi?
You know what? In small ways, yeah. I feel like after my last 3 years in this business has been so insanely crazy, and I always thought I was like an extrovert. And then being so exposed in the media and having cameras everywhere and just being like, perceived in general.
It's a lot.
The way she just melts, I'm like, that is me. I am she. We are the same.
So if you were to have the chance to enter any anime universe, which universe would you choose?
Oh, not Attack on Titan.
Because you want to live.
Smart.
Solid. Mm-hmm.
Oh, God. I mean, I want to say a Ghibli universe.
They're so
but that's
pretty.
Yeah.
Which movie? Which movie? Real quick.
Okay.
Movie?
Okay. So Howl's Moving Castle.
Ooh.
That's
gorgeous castle in the sky.
I would choose Howl's Moving Castle right at the ending when it's all peace and love.
Why is panels on Twitch? Why is panels on Twitch so finicky, man?
Or if there was a giant Twitter in my backyard, I would not be mad about that.
That's very true.
And I want to ask, what is the? Oh, you already know this answer to this one. What's the first anime you watched?
Garn having scuff.
Yes, actually, Demon Slayer. But
bro, I'm fighting for my life out here, man. I'm fighting for my life, and it's not.
Thank you so much. Have fun tonight, Iman, and thank you for taking the time to talk with us.
Thank you so much. Hi, nice to meet you.
This is a real life. We're talking right now. Okay, so thanks so much, Iman. And we want to talk. We're gonna talk a little bit about. I want to let you guys know about the theme song, actually, for the Crunchyroll Anime Awards. So it's something that we haven't touched on yet. So this theme song for the Anime Awards was created by none other than the legendary Hiroyuki Sawano and Kota Yamamoto, and they'll be performing.
Wait, what?
The theme song live. In the show,
Hiroyuki Sawano made the theme song for this.
The new opening on Crunchyroll after the show, of course. You know, you have to watch the show and then check it out. You know, so it's a crazy honor to have
you for real.
Craft our theme song and performance.
That's fuck. That's hype as shit, man.
It is going to be so cool. That's all coming up in the main show. But right now, let's check back in with Lauren.
Let's welcome Ilona Garcia back to the carpet, and she is going to be helping us out with one more award. You ready?
Yes. So these anime have mastered the art of visual language by developing stunning scene compositions that transport audiences into the worlds they are creating. Your nominees are...
Best Cinematography. Attack on Titan, Final Season, The Final Chapters, Special One. MAPPA. Chainsaw Man, MAPPA. Demon Slayer, Kimetsu no Yaiba, Swordsmith Village Arc. UFO Table. Heavenly Delusion, Production IG. Jujutsu Kaisen Season 2, MAPPA. Vinland Saga Season 2,
I don't know what's going to win this one, actually.
And your winner for Best Cinematography is... Jujutsu Kaisen Season 2.
Okay. Well, to be fair, Jujutsu Kaisen, especially the first half, that insane cinematography. So,
anytime. I'm here every year if you want me to.
Every year. I'm
every
writing
year.
That down. Everyone take notes. So we are so close to the beginning of the 2024 Crunchyroll Anime Awards, and there is just a little more time left for our pre-show, so stick around.
Just like Lauren said, the main show is coming real soon, and we also have upcoming talent still, Lisa, Aquaria, and Porter Robinson. Ooh, exciting. All right, Lena, should we announce a few more special category winners before we head to the main show?
Let's do it, Tim. It's time to celebrate another round of amazing anime voice actor talent. Take a look and
all
right. We'll be right back.
Everything's fixed. Everything is
Best
fixed.
Voice artist performance, German.
We can get Hansi back Kwanzaa. To it.
Power.
We can get back to
Chainsaw
it.
Man, MAPPA.
Wait.
Best voice artist performance. Latin Spanish.
Shit, not fixed.
Emilio Trevino, Denji, Chainsaw Man, MAPPA.
All right, now it's fixed. Yo, I felt like I was disarming a bomb there. I was like, oh, you gotta fix this. I'm like, oh shit. Okay.
Welcome back, everyone. If you are just joining us, we are here on the orange carpet for the 2024 Anime Awards pre-show in Tokyo.
The main show is just around the corner.
Guess right, what? Let me make sure they know that everything is fixed.
Winner.
right now.
Lena and Mikey, you want to come down? You want to come down?
Come on down. This is a category that I know fans are excited for. Best supporting character.
This category.
Oh, shit. This is the hype one. Please, Reagan. It's going to be Gojo. It's going to be Gojo, but please, Reagan.
When called upon, right, guys? You're right.
And here are your nominees.
Best Supporting Character. Arataka Reagan, Mob Psycho 103, Bones. Hanji Zoe.
Oh, I want Reagan so bad. Reagan deserves it so much, but it's going to be Gojo. It's going to be Gojo, man.
Chainsaw Man, Mappa. Satoru Gojo, Jujutsu Kaisen Season 2, Mappa. Tsuguru Getto, Jujutsu Kaisen Season 2, Mappa.
Alright, drum roll please! And the winner is...
Oh, you have to read this.
Satoru Gojo.
Of course! Pour one out for my bro Reagan. Pour one out.
Congratulations to all of you.
Pour one out for my bro Reagan.
Voted for them because I know that category was tough. Ooh. The competition was tough.
Reagan deserved it so much, man. He deserved it so much. He did. He worked so hard. My boy Reagan worked so hard, man.
Why do you say that?
He did so much for Mob.
All right, you guys.
The character development, the ending of Mob Psycho Season 3.
We have that interview.
Oh man.
And right after, we'll reveal more winners for the best voice
actor. Oh, did the volume just go down?
Japanese and English. So first, let's check it out.
すごくこうアニメ業界にいろんなポジティブな影響をしたと思うんですけど、まあ今日こういう形で受賞式でアワードプレゼンする意気込みについて。はい、もうとてももう総合のアニメーションを代表した。プレゼンターということでとても光栄に思いますし、とても
Wait, Lisa? They got Lisa? Wait, hold on a second, hold on!
私もまだ知らないのでとても楽しみにしています。
全世界でこの生配信を見ているファンたちに対してメッセージ
。 Yo, this is hype!
はい、私もドキドキワクワクしていますので一緒にワクワクしながら見てください。
で、バックアップのボーカリストとしてアニメキャラを一人しか選べなかったとするとどのキャラを選べますか？
バックアップ、私のバックアップ、
はい、
そうですね、私はソロで最初に関わった作品が
I remember Fate Zero, man, the first. Oh,
ライダー、あ、イスカンダル。
Yeah, what?
Thank you.
Yo, how based? How fucking based? The Giga Chad, man.
Denji, Chainsaw Man, Mappa.
She is the one. She is the one. Fucking goated, man.
Ichi Nakamura, Satoru Gojo, Jujutsu Kaisen Season 2, Mappa.
Of course. Gojo winning best voice actor performance.
Congratulations to the voice actor winners. Congratulations to Riot as well. That is awesome. Also, I gotta talk about how cool Lisa is.
All right. And let me.
So cool.
Oh my goodness. I need to bring the chat back up. You were just her presence.
No need to brag.
You know what?
No need to brag, okay?
I'm low-key looking forward to the performance tonight. Just saying, guys.
No bias at all.
But her dress was just. Oh, stunning. She saw that, right?
Oh my gosh. Beautiful.
She has transformed the anime opening, music, everything in the industry, right?
So many openings. And also, there's a lot of cool presenters in the main show.
Oh, so many.
Of course, we have, you know. I think my favorite person right now that's about to present could be Megan Thee Stallion, anybody?
Okay.
Does anybody know about
her? A little anime hottie,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. Does anybody know about
her? See, when Megan Thee Stallion got announced, I was like full boomer. I was like, who is this person? I do not know who this person is.
How anime has just
which just shows how out of touch I am with the music, with the music crowd, man.
But, you know, anime was this thing that you kind of had to hide.
It wasn't cool,
but now it was like, look at all this.
Look at all this.
Right?
All right, guys, speaking of cool guests, Lauren is back with another celeb to present.
She's popular, yes, so I do know she is popular.
Her.
Thanks, Lena.
The literal most popular woman artist.
Welcome. Thank you so much for joining us.
This just shows how little I listen to modern music, man. Also, most popular woman artist is a big statement when Taylor Swift is when Taylor Swift exists, man.
James from Team Rocket and Pokemon. You know, she knows how to get in the drags, always in a costume.
Perfect answer. All right, well, let's reveal some more winners.
All right. Whether it's a surprising fresh perspective or the witty exchanges, the humor in these shows will make you laugh out loud and have your sides hurting at the end.
Oh, this is best comedy?
Kind of like right now in this corset. So, your nominees for best comedy are...
Lots of L cakes this year, but Lisa's the goat Sawano and another
comedy.
One.
Best comedy. Mochi the Rock. Cloverworks.
Gotta go.
Buddy Dad.
Bye chat and PA make
works.
The more fun for our Mashle, boys.
Magic Thank you very much, man. Thank you.
A1 Pictures.
Okay, what I want to win this is Bocce. What I want to win is Bocce. What I think is going to win is Spy Family. I'm calling it out. Spy Family is going to win this one. But I would like Bocce to win.
And your winner for best comedy is... Spy Family!
Yay! I'm too good! I'm too good, baby!
Thank you so much, Aquaria. Oh my gosh. It's been an honor having you here. Really, really glad for you to join us. So enjoy the rest of your evening. Thank you so much.
Thank you, thank you. Woo! Congratulations. I cannot believe it's almost time for the main award show. Thank you to everyone who have been watching us from around the world. As
Hell yeah.
We do some reveals. It's been pretty sick to share this one with everybody, honestly.
It has been so cool, and I cannot wait for the main show to start.
Me too.
We have one more special category award to share with our viewers at home before the main award show starts. So this is the award for best opening sequence, so it only made sense to bring in the one and only...
It's gotta be Oshinoko. It's gotta be, right?
Hello, Anime Awards. This is Porter Robinson.
It's gotta be.
While I could not be on the orange carpet this year, I am excited to announce the category of Best Opening Sequence. So right now, we are moments away from the start of the 2024 Crunchyroll Anime Awards, where we're going to hear the custom opening theme song composed by Hiroyuki Sawano and Koto Yamamoto for the very first time. So it's only fitting that we now present the award for Best Opening Sequence. In anime, an unforgettable opening sequence can really make all the difference, and it's my personal favorite part of anime in general.
But is Jujutsu Kaisen going to win this? Okay. I do want Oshinoko to win. No, it's got to be Oshinoko. Okay, even Jujutsu Kaisen cannot overpower the idol becoming the top, like, the... Like Kenshi the Yonezu, top one of the Billboard Chainsaw Top 100 Man, Global. Mama. There's no way. There's no way. Like, Hanabu, there's no way.
Zom 100, Bucket List of the Dead, Bug Films, Work, Ringo Sheena and Millennium Parade.
Like, okay, Jujutsu Kaisen popularity, Mama. Yes. But in terms of, like, Where the pure blue? Song,
Tatsuya Kitani.
I'm calling it Idol is my vote, and Idol is going to win this one. Idol is going to win this one.
Now let's go back to the orange carpet to announce the grand winner.
It's gonna be Idol.
And the winner for best opening sequences.
Where Our Blue Is by Tatsuya Kitani, Jujutsu Kaisen Season 2, Hidden Inventory, Premature Death.
Woo!
Congratulations! Woo!
Congratulations!
Woo! I am.
All right, so let's bring
I am
back
shook.
Lauren and Mikey onto the
stage. I am.
Hello.
I am shook.
Hello. Hello.
What? I genuinely, with how much of an impact Idol has made, I am genuinely shocked. I am shocked. Like, it was like the first Japanese song on the Billboard Top 100. I am shocked that didn't win. Wow.
What was your favorite?
Wow.
Well. My favorite
okay,
moment.
If Idol couldn't
yes.
win,
oh,
if Idol couldn't win
oh
against,
oh, right, yeah.
with
oh,
how big of an impact that made, if Idol couldn't win Mr. against Jujutsu Kaisen, I don't think anything has a chance of winning against Jujutsu Kaisen.
Very proud of him.
Oh, like I said, actor. You know he's not real, right? He's a character.
What?
You got oh my gosh. Okay, Mikey, what about you? What
you
was
know,
your favorite
my
part?
My favorite moment is just all the wardrobe. I'm just amazed by how elevated anime has become because this is my, like, childhood.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I grew up in Japan. It's just been amazing to see the growth of anime over the last 20 years. So I think you guys have been to that same vibe, right? You know what I'm talking about.
Jujutsu Kaisen fans?
Yeah, exactly.
Yo, Jujutsu Kaisen fans.
So
are like, they're the new Hive Minds, man. They have Anime Expo is like bonded together to make an organism on their own.
Absolutely.
College, like,
34 million votes. I'm interested to see how much the vote breakdown is compared to the judge voting for this year.
Watching anime. Yeah. Look at us now.
If you ever heard, you won't get a job watching anime.
Yeah, you will. Look at us.
Tim. Okay, Tim, if you had to choose, what was your favorite part?
So if I had to choose, it would be obviously the lovely seeing all the amazing guests that walk by. I also did sneak peek the Bong Joon-ho walking past you guys, giving the funny face. And also in the VIP section when I was hanging out, he was there. I was sweating. My hands were getting sweaty. Yeah. I was like literally hanging out back there.
He's like, I'm breathing the same air.
One of my coworkers like, oh, Bong Joon-ho's there. And I was just there right behind their crew, froze. Just like,
oh no.
Well, guys.
You have to like.
Well, guys, my hopium for Vinland Saga Season 2 winning Anime of the Year is going down. It's going down with every award that they announce. My hope is just going down with every award, man. These tickets still happen. It could still happen, right, guys? Right. They could do it. They could. They could turn it around, right?
Seconds away when we bring anime fans together from all around the globe to celebrate the stories, creators, and worlds that we love.
It's the 2024 Crunchyroll Anime Awards, and it starts right now.
Hell yeah, let's go!
Right now. It started. Oh.
Okay, go watch.
Anime has inspired me for over 20 years and has given me strength and courage I couldn't imagine.
Pour moi, l'anime est un refuge à l'abri des soucis.
Per me, gli anime sono stati una bellissima parte della mia vita.
Anime sono un medium per me.
Anime sono un medium
per me.
I hope anime creators know just how much their work means to fans around the world.
Yo, they fucking leveled up this year, man. Hiroyuki Sawano performing the awards? What is going on? That was the drop. We got the drop, ladies and gentlemen. We got the Sawano drop. Oh, hell yeah. The real question is, are we going to get a bigger drop? That was literally the quietest Sawano drop I've ever heard. When Sawano decides to drop with a single piano note, I'm just like, oh. All right. Sawano presses the key. Depression cured. Accurate.
Hey,
can't hear the piano, bro. We heard the one key. We heard the one note. That's all you need, man. That's all we needed. My bro said E minor. I'm like, Sawano, you're a fucking genius. Yo, he's in the element, man. Triple drop. E minor drop was my favorite. I wonder how big this award is. Wonder if we're gonna get an audience shot to see how big the award is and how many people are in the audience. There it is! There it is! That's the Sawano drop! Alright, that's the Sawano I know. That's the Sawano I know, man. That's why he's the GOAT! The GOAT! Oh, no more drop. That's it. That's it. Yo, Sawano performing at the Anime Awards, man. How far we've come. I met that guy. I met him. He doesn't remember meeting me, but I met him for like 1 second. 1 second. Across 200 countries and territories. $34 million votes. And 30 of them was for JJK. If the awards continue, that's probably what the place is gonna be like. If the awards continue like it has for the previous awards, that's probably what it's going to be. There's gotta be a lot of votes for Jujutsu Kaisen. 33.9 million. Why no Didus? Because we're not having a watch party today. Well, we are. I'm having a party with you guys. Oh, Sally Amaki, let's go! Let's fucking go! Yo, Sally,
good
so
evening,
much
everybody.
Fun,
welcome to the 2024 Crunchyroll Anime Awards. I'm your host, John Kabira.
Yo, idol spy in disguise, guys.
And I'm Sally Amaki. We are coming to you live from Tokyo. Hello, John.
Hello, Sally.
Sally-san.
Hi.
It's so good to see you.
Yeah, I noticed the dub this year. They've gotten two different dub actors this time.
What an honor to have Hiroyuki Sawano and Kota Yamamoto compose and perform our brand new theme song. I feel very lucky and proud to be part of this historic moment.
Why no subtitles, bro? It's live. I want live subtitles right now.
And I feel honored that the greatest creators in the world of anime have joined us once again in this lovely ballroom at the Grand Prince Hotel Shin Takanawa. We sincerely thank you.
Oh, thank you very much, Rob, for the raid. Hope you have a good stream.
Thank you to everyone.
Hey guys, we are watching the Anime Awards 2024 right now.
It feels like a beautiful, precious gift when the world of the
welcome to the stream. We're celebrating the best of anime that came out last year with the Anime Awards.
You'll see another reflection of the impact anime has on the world. Because our presenters joining us are distinguished in their crafts and coming from countries all around the world to celebrate with us.
I agree. And tonight, we are here to celebrate another amazing year of anime. We'll see some brand new titles.
It was a pretty damn good year of anime, guys. Pretty damn good.
Classic favorites, some of which are celebrating huge milestone anniversaries.
It's been an incredible year for anime, as the number of people watching continues to skyrocket. We wanted to honor this massive global reach by bringing the fans who are passionate about anime together with their favorite creators.
No matter where we live, fans
of anime, do we want to keep it on the dub, or do we want to go raw and just watch the original... The original
That's
Japanese
true.
Broadcast.
And it ripples out from there. Anime inspires fans across the world to embrace their own artistic side and creativity, encouraging people to believe that there's no obstacle too large to overcome.
Raw? Raw for... Okay.
Absolutely. Now, we will go into the ceremony itself. Let's welcome our first guest.
All right. Dub is okay. Well, the thing is, guys, how weeb do you want to go? Because I know that
Sony Group Corporation, Kenichiro,
and I know that most of you guys can't understand Japanese, so you are literally just going to be nodding along, being like, yes.
Welcome and thank you for joining the 2024 Crunchyroll Anime Awards.
I don't understand Japanese, but raw. Are we going for you? Going
hello
full
to all
weep?
The anime fans around the world watching the live stream.
Let me see if there is a rule.
This year marks the 8th year of this prestigious event, honoring the achievements of anime and anime creators. This past year, with new and returning series and films attracting many fans, anime has continued to grow as an entertainment choice. None of this would be possible without the individuals who breathe life into the anime's fantastic.
Let's do a poll, actually. I'll do a poll on Twitch.
Tonight's honors celebrate over 50 TV series and films, and more than 50 voice actors and music artists. My respect goes out to the creative community whose visionary work takes us on journeys that surpass our imagination. I would also like to express our sincere gratitude to all the fans who cast a record 34 million votes, nearly twice as many as last year, to make their diverse voices heard from nearly 200 countries and regions.
All right, I'll start a poll.
We believe that entertainment, including anime, has the power to connect people.
Oh, it's pretty close. It's pretty damn close. All right. It's fucking 50-50. What? All right, we'll keep it on the English dub. You guys have spoken. Oh my god. All right, you guys have spoken. 50-50. No one wins. Therefore, we keep it.
In the imaginative worlds of creators. In honor of this.
It's the weebs fighting against the, it's the weebs fighting against, hey.
The theme of this year's awards.
I actually want to understand what's going on. I actually want to understand what's happening, man. All right, let's see what's next. Raw 1?
I am extremely grateful to be able to celebrate anime and the anime creators with everyone tonight.
Respect the law.
Thank you.
Ah, no, man. If it's that close, I'll keep it on dubbed. If I was expecting it to be a landslide, I'm gonna go dictator mode, and I'm gonna keep it on dubbed. I don't know if any of the YouTube watchers voted on it, so you know. It's not a big enough sample size for me to be convinced. If it was that close.
Thank you, Yoshida-san, for those inspirational words. And now let's get started with our first award of the night, Best Original Anime.
Best Original Anime!
You probably recognize her voice. This iconic international superstar, singer, songwriter, won an anime award herself in 2022. Please welcome Lisa.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Yo, she's back. Man, what goated taste, man.
I'm thrilled to be here tonight to present the award for Best Original Anime. These creators somehow pulled fresh new ideas out of thin air and cultivated them until they blossomed into unique stories that the world has never seen before. And they continually excite, thrill, and surprise us as they unfold.
All right, let's see this.
Best Original Anime. Akiba Maid Sensou. Akiba Maid.
This was okay. Oh, I love this scene. This is one of my favorite scenes, man. Has anyone seen the out of context clip of Akiba Maid Wars where the main character's like eating a lot of stuff and then she just randomly throws up? That's my favorite gif from this one series, man. It's so unhinged. Ah, yes! Birdie Wing! Let's go! Let's go, Birdie Wing! Hell yeah, this made golf fun.
Buddy daddies. Buddy daddies.
This is cute. I think Miri is the best part of this. Miri is the more realistic portrayal of anime children. She's like the opposite of Anya, you know?
Do it yourself.
Oh, do it yourself. So comfy. Oh my god. This one's also... Hell yeah! Witch from Mercury!
The Witch from Mercury.
Do you think Gundam has this? I don't know because, like, I don't know how popular Witch from Mercury got overseas, but it was massive here in Japan. Witch from Mercury was absolutely massive here in Japan, man. I did not watch this one.
Ah!
I think Gundam's what? I think Gundam's got this one. I think it was good enough, and in terms of like original anime, there wasn't one that really, really stood out from the rest of the nominations. I'm calling it Gundam. Gundam.
The anime award goes to
Buddy Daddies?
Buddy Daddies.
Whoa! What? That came out of left field. I did not think that would, like... I did not think that that could have overpowered some of the other nominations, man. Yo! That was a genuine surprise. Whoa, guess I got a drink. To be fair, the best original anime,
thank you very much.
I think out of everyone of the nominations is probably the most balanced in terms of how much of a chance each show has to win that one.
Receiving such a large anime award, the fact that Buddy Daddies won this award, I'm very grateful. Thank you very much for the best original anime. This piece is about two men who have never raised children.
Yep.
And they do their best to raise children. It is a comedy. Myself, I have actually not experienced raising children, so.
Oh.
Now I feel the difficulty of raising children along with the main characters.
Oh.
And so, I feel that our characters have really spoken to the audience, and that's why we received this award. Thank you very much.
Oh. Hell yeah. I'll clap for that.
Best character design, this actress charged into the Marvel Cinematic Universe as Kamala Khan in the hit television series Miss Marvel. Please welcome to the stage.
I have not seen Miss Marvel yet.
Super teen hero from the Marvels, which graced movie screens all over the world this summer. Iman Vellani.
I wish the dub guy got his got his inflection there, man. Yo.
Gosh, I feel so
superhero.
Be here tonight to think that some of my favorite anime characters were created by the very same.
I don't even need subtitles.
I am sharing a room with right now. It's crazy. It is truly an honor to be breathing the same air as you all. Actually, that brings me to one of the things that this category celebrates, the unique style given to a character that makes them instantly recognizable.
Character design, Jujutsu Kaisen is going to win. I'm seeing a pattern, guys. Jujutsu Kaisen is going to win. But
each design is a labor of love,
but
a testament to the dedication and maybe, the talent of the
maybe some other shows have a chance,
here
right?
Here are the nominees for best character design.
Best character design. Chainsaw Man.
I mean, Chainsaw Man has great designs as well. Oh.
Kimetsu no Yaiba, Katanakaji no Sato Hen. Demon Slayer.
You know, for once, I don't think Demon Slayer has it. Remember 2 years ago when the answer was Demon Slayer? I don't think they have this one anymore, man. I don't think they have this one anymore.
Jigokuraku. Hell's Paradise.
I enjoyed Hell's Paradise. I wouldn't say that it's as strong as some of the other contenders, though. In terms of character designs. Actually, no. No, actually, as actually really liked the different characters in Hell's Paradise.
Jujutsu Kaisen 第2期 Jujutsu Kaisen Season 2.
Okay, well, Gojo is gonna overpower. This is gonna win.
Oshinoko.
I can't remember who I voted for this one. I think I might have voted for Oshinoko. I like how they use this clip as well. No, I voted for Trigun, but that has no chance. That has no chance. No chance at all. Yo, let's go. But, no but. Trigun has no chance. I know he has no chance.
And the anime award goes to... Oh boy. Jujutsu Kaisen Season 2.
Yeah, she didn't even pause for dramatic effect there. She didn't even pause for dramatic effect. She was like, I know what it's gonna be. Alright. I'm gonna take the quickest piss break of my life, guys.
My name is Hiramatsu. On Jujutsu Kaisen, I started in Season 1, and this is the award for Season 2. Season 2, after designing the main characters, I would say this award really belongs to the young staff members that I handed it over to. So it's really thanks to them that I'm able to receive this award. I'd like to express my gratitude to the staff. Thank you very much.
We've spoken so much about how anime reaches all around the globe. And to prove our point,
okay.
They wanted to be here tonight, but since they've been nominated again for an Academy Award, they're coming to us via video all the way from Hollywood, California. Please welcome the Academy Award-winning filmmakers who are known for films like Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse.
I've been streaming for 3 hours. I'm like, ooh. You know how it is, guys. You know how it is.
Tokyo, we're thrilled to help celebrate this incredible year in anime.
Oh,
just
shit!
Like all of you, Phil and I
the duo from Spider-Verse?
It's the
wait, what?
Of visuals and storytelling
where wait, hold up.
Runs wild, plot lines challenge norms, and where artistry truly shines. The influence that anime's had on our work and on the whole world of animation is undeniable.
What stuns me is how anime has always been absolutely fearless with breaking the boundaries of artistry. And that bravery is contagious. It encourages creators like us to take big risks and push the envelope.
And that's why we're so excited and honored to introduce an award category that is close to our hearts, Best Animation.
We would give anything to be in Tokyo tonight,
I mean,
but do not worry.
Hell yeah. If anyone deserves to present this award, it's Spider-Verse because their animation, the animation was on another level. It's going to be Jujutsu Kaisen, and I think this is the one award that Jujutsu Kaisen definitely deserves as well. It's going to be JJK, and JJK genuinely deserves this one.
Thank you, Phil and
Chris. This one's an easy. This one's an easy award.
Animation director, we know how challenging.
Or Chainsaw Man? No.
To make it's
Jujutsu Kaisen.
In order to create a complete
package. I do think Jujutsu Kaisen has better animation than Chainsaw Man. Myself,
everyone
as a fan,
here,
as well.
In this room, has a deep understanding of the hard work that goes into what we see on screen. It takes the perfect combination.
Mob deserved.
Of visually stunning style, a compelling narrative.
Mob is up there. Mob is definitely up there. But in terms of like an animation showcase, I think Season 2 was stronger than Season 3. Season 3 really shined because of its writing and just bringing everything to a close.
Kind of dedication. The right visionaries, amazing animators, great writing,
and just a bit of magic from every person involved to bring it all to life. Here are this year's incredible nominees for Best Animation.
Saiyushu Animation Show, Best Animation. Shingeki no Kyojin, The Final Season.
Oh, I forgot this was announced. I think Attack on Titan final season got overshadowed a lot by, you know, Jujutsu Kaisen and stuff, but I generally think how the animation has evolved season per season when it changed to MAPPA, I do think that final season is the best looking that Attack on Titan has been. Like, they really, really leveled up.
Chainsaw Man.
It feels Shibuya, yeah. I feel like a lot of people haven't taken into account that we're not counting the Shibuya arc, but even so, the first arc of Season 2 was still really well animated as well.
Kimetsu no Yaiba, Katanakaji no Sato Hen, Demon Slayer, Kimetsu no Yaiba, Swordsmith Village Arc.
I mean, basically, it's MAPPA versus MAPPA versus MAPPA, right? And also, I think Demon Slayer, this was, in terms of action, not comparable to the second season. Yeah. So many fights in this, and the cinematography as well, since it won the award, was definitely on point. Mob Psycho Season 3, yep.
Mob Psycho,
this had one really, really well animated scene. And it's this one. Yo, the animation was so good that the bitrate crashed, man. That's how you know.
Trigun Stampede.
And then there's Trigun Stampede. I mean, I'm happy that Orange is getting some recognition for what they're doing with 3D animation. But really, the top contenders are the MAPPA Show or the MAPPA Show or the MAPPA Show.
And the anime award goes to
JJK.
If I can get it open. Demon Slayer, Kimetsu no Yaiba.
What? Wait, what? Oh my god. Wait, I'm surprised. I'm actually surprised. Wait. The one time I thought Jujutsu Kaisen was a shoo-in. What? It was Demon Slayer.
What?
Thank you, honey. Alright, I guess I'm taking another drink.
My name is Koenishi Moji. And first off, I'm just grateful to be selected for such an award.
Of course, I'm fucking cursing this awards, man. The one time when I'm like, yes, you guys, and it's like, I genuinely, they deserve this one. It's one where they 100% deserve this one. This is it. This is the one, guys.
Myself felt I wanted to be a part of that world. And that's how I started. So, I never thought I would receive such a wonderful award and that I would be able to speak to you all here. So, it's really a dream come true. And that dream...
All right, guys. Do you know what the big thing is, though, guys?
Thanks to everyone, all the fans of anime around the world.
Do you know what the big thing is? Okay, guys, hear me out. Theory time. Theory crafting time. This means that JJK is beatable.
When I think of collaboration, I can't help but look at our orchestra and imagine how musical notes can be played one by one.
That means it's beatable, right? That means Vinland Saga Season 2 has a chance. Gojo can bleed, guys. We have a chance for Vinland Saga Season 2 winning Anime of the Year. There's a chance.
Animators and musicians.
who turn universal themes into incredible adventures.
I can hope, okay.
This feeling of togetherness doesn't end there. It reaches out into the world, touching the hearts and minds of all fans, igniting their passions. That's why tonight we wanted to honor them and give them a chance to have their voices heard by all of the creators who inspired them.
All right. Chef and teacher. Ooh.
Vengo da Roma, Italia, e faccio il cuoco professionale. Ho avuto un'infanzia felicissima.
Oh, Italian?
Mi sono innamorato.
This was not something I was expecting.
E mentre poi ho scoperto il mio secondo amore, i cartoni animati giapponesi, gli anime. A Roma. Tanti americani venivano al mio ristorante e mi dicevano: "Vieni in America e diventi
unfortunately, what's the any Italians in here? Any Italians? Can you translate for me?
Yeah, in Milwaukee.
Oh, Milwaukee! No fucking way! For Sydney district. They're showcasing Milwaukee.
Professional career when I watch anime because
Sydney. People, they're in Milwaukee right now.
Everybody.
They're showcasing like anime across the world.
I try to find something that could connect. So what we're gonna make today is something inspired by.
You remember that place, Gar?
We've been there. We had a date there.
I was there.
Yeah.
Croquette. You can see Japanese cuisine, Italian cuisine.
Oh. Oh,
why are they here?
This guy is like an anime fan.
Born from a dream.
Is he a chef?
Yeah, he's a chef.
The noodles. What could be best?
Yo, Milwaukee mentioned. Let's go.
That is gonna be memorable. The Japanese crepe, a tiramisu matcha that can blend the two worlds together through the anime. The thing that
aww. Is that my high school?
That in the anime you always.
Oh, no, okay. Wait a minute.
When it's honor, when it's integrity,
I'll
if only
up.
One out of a class feel moved, that purpose is be completed.
Wait,
just like putting chocolate in a ramen, matcha in a tiramisu.
Wait, holy shit! I
you guys
wait.
Make your own.
Oh, this is college. Oh, thank God. I was wondering, like, damn, about to get there to dox myself.
Hey,
so with other enthusiasts around the globe, together they can move mountains. In this spirit, it's time for a special musical performance to celebrate all the incredible collaborations that happen in the world of anime.
Milwaukee is real. This is the only time I've seen Milwaukee mentioned, and it didn't include beer or cheese.
And to honor this momentous occasion,
close the door.
Please welcome hip hop artist Shingo 2, DJ Spin Master A1, and all the way from Manchester, England, Oma, who will deliver an
exclusive. Oh, he's from Manchester! Let's go!
Battle Cry.
Coming up, more Anime Awards 2024. クランチロールアニメアワード2024まだまだ続きます
まだまだ Alright, we'll continue. We're continuing.
At Bandai Namco, we approach everything we do first
Hashtag ads. Hashtag ads.
And it's our mission to transform dreams into reality.
Everything oh, is this the Gunpla? Is this the Gunpla studio?
The desire to play and resonate with fans on a genuine emotional level.
Some good Alan.
We make toys, collectibles, video games, and more to unlock new realms of possibilities for everyone, from children to adults. Our creations are an
Digimon
with endless possibilities.
Digimon.
This is an ever-evolving journey. And we look forward to seeing you there with us every step of the way.
Did I just see Code Geass?
Welcome back to the 2024 Crunchyroll Anime Awards. We've barely started the show and can already see the incredible effect anime has on people around the world.
Oh, man.
Now,
what a voice,
on to
man.
Another award.
Not the dub.
It's time to present the award for best
I love his voice.
Honoring an exceptional anime that effortlessly excites its audience from episode to episode and maintains excellence season after season. And for this award, we wanted someone who knows about stamina and never giving up, which is why we are honored to welcome a talent whose physical abilities are closest to those of anime heroes, Sota Kai.
Wait!
In life, I draw so much inspiration from the heroes of anime. When I was faced with obstacles that seemed impossible, watching anime gave me the energy to master new skills. It taught me to train, learn, and become stronger. And that there's no opponent too strong and no challenge I can
I swear to God, I recognize him from somewhere.
I'm excited to present the award for best continuing series because I know the type of stamina, dedication, and determination it takes to produce something that you're passionate about. These nominees worked hard to bring together the
athletes.
Best
okay,
platform.
Okay.
Well-crafted narratives.
I must be
beautiful animation
of someone
and
else.
Determined heroes who always come out on top.
Okay.
My favorite part. Here are the nominees for best continuing series.
I've probably seen him somewhere on some poster somewhere. I was like, wait, I've seen this face before. I swear to God. Alright, best continuing series, One Piece. One Piece is gonna win. One Piece is gonna win. Wait, does Jujutsu Kaisen count in this one as well?
Attack on Titan, final season. The final chapters, special one.
Wait, why not both specials? I like how special one won and not the actual special two. Not the actual ending of it.
Kimetsu no Yaiba.
Yo, that last Demon Slayer victory has got me all confused, man. I'm like, wait, what if it's Demon Slayer? Alright, this is literally going to be a contender of like all of the most popular anime that aired last year, man. Cause where else is there? Jujutsu Kaisen's there gonna be, right?
Jujutsu Kaisen.
I feel like One Piece can beat Jujutsu Kaisen. I feel like... I feel like it's One Piece. Because we had Gear 5 animated last year in One Piece, right? Surely. One Piece. Yeah, exactly. We had Gear 5 animated last year. Alright, I'm calling it. Out of all of those... Oh, Spy Family. Okay, you have a chance, Spy Family. Spy Family versus Jujutsu Kaisen, Demon Slayer, fucking Attack on Titan, and Anya, and One Piece. Anya, you're cute. But this is a heavyweight category right now, man. If they won, it would be the biggest... Oh, no! Vinland Saga! God damn it! Why did you have to be here, Vinland Saga? Why? So I could watch you lose? No! Alright. I feel like best continuing series. Best... Of course I want Vinland Saga to win, but I think it's One Piece. It's One Piece, right?
One Piece.
That's it. Wrap it up. There's two things that could beat Jujutsu Kaisen. It's One Piece and it's Demon Slayer. Has there been a year where One Piece hasn't won Best Continuing Series of the Year? Has that actually been a year? But One Piece hasn't won it.
Thank you very much. I'm a director, Koyama. Thank you very much for everybody. Everybody who gets involved in One Piece. It's such an honor.
Joey was right about Jujutsu Kaisen. Mid. One Piece all the way.
Yo, JJK, hey, mid, man. Let's not let the saltiness
including myself
of the awards
and ourselves
distract you that Jujutsu Kaisen is a fucking great action series, man. Joey, that your alt account? Joey, that your alt account, my bro?
We hope to spread the anime inspiration to the world. Thank you very much.
The presenter of Best Art Direction is one of the biggest stars of the Indian film industry, gracing the cinematic canvas with a versatility across multiple Indian languages.
Yo, India mentioned! India mentioned!
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. As a big fan of anime, I see a lot of similarities with the movies back.
Fellow Indians
it's
in chat.
Why anime do you, is huge all who is, over India.
Who is this? Do you know this person?
Heart and is a visually stunning feast for the eyes. In both cases, we have our directors to thank. These unsung heroes weave together plot, style,
art direction is going to be a hard one because I feel like most people voting on art direction are not 100% sure.
And I know it inspires many other artists out there too.
There's a lot of people who, you know, talk about art direction and have no idea what the fuck they're talking about. I'm one of those people. I'm like, oh, it has pretty colors and stuff like that. That's good art direction, right?
Chainsaw Man.
I mean, the only one that sticks out to me is Zom 100 because I love the use of colors. Zom 100 is not going to win. Alright, it's going to be back to Jujutsu Kaisen. Back to JJK to claim its throne.
Swordsmith Village Arc.
Chainsaw Man? I like Chainsaw Man's art direction as well. I mean, I like Chainsaw Man's direction in general.
Jigokurak, Hell's Paradise.
What's the difference between art direction and animation? Animation is movement, my good bro. I actually think that the cinematography and direction of the first half of Jujutsu Kaisen was better in the second season. The Shibuya arc was just like all action and action direction, but in terms of like storytelling and stuff, I actually think the first half is superior. I loved the aesthetic in Zom 100.
Yatta!
Oh, this scene, man. This scene.
Look at this shit, man.
Oh, it didn't show him like exploding in a bunch of colors. Hi, honey.
And the anime award goes to?
Someone from India.
Demon Slayer.
Oh my god!
Swordsmith Villager.
Oh my god! Yes. That was good, honey.
I told you, honey!
It was a lot, though. I mean, for our direction, I'll allow it. For our direction in Demon Slayer, I'll allow it.
Thank you very much for this wonderful award. I'm the voice actor. Usually, voice actors, it's weird that we're in front of you to receive applause. But as our direction,
good job,
I would like everyone to give a big round of applause for the staff that are present today. The Swordsmith Village Arc was when all of our heroes combat a very dangerous big enemy.
Should have been Chainsaw Man, I mean.
And the fans who have been supporting us have been...
Chainsaw Man was also very good. In terms of like art, Demon Slayer has always been good though.
The film is
Demon Slayer has always been good in terms of just like pure art direction and animation.
Wherever in the world,
and that's the two things I will defend about Demon Slayer.
Everyone has for Kimetsu no Yaiba.
That is the two things I will defend about Demon Slayer.
And this is dialogue from the anime.
I thought you were co-streaming the anime awards. Why are we watching a robbery?
Bro.
Zom 100 should have won.
Yo, you know how the really awards work, like, man. I wanted Zom 100 to win as well, man. Shonen too strong.
We hope that we can continue answering to that. To that wonderful passion of fans. And that we will burn our very souls to create... to continue create Demon Slayer. Thank you very much.
Demon Slayer winning too many awards. I think that
he's an entertainer.
Demon Slayer is winning less awards than it usually does, actually. It's funny, eh? It's funny. Normally, it's like Demon Slayer absolutely sweeping everything. And this, we're living in a year where I'm like, yeah, Demon Slayer is actually winning less than it usually does. Oh, Roland's back! Roland is back! Look, our only hopes, my fellow bros, is when we get to the romance, is when we get to the romance awards. That's the award where there will be no shonen, where there will be your equal standing. There will be no shonen.
I suppose you don't know who I am, right? But I think it was a shot, and you've got.
Oh shit! He's breaking out the ego, man. He's breaking out the ego.
Okay. Anyways, I will talk about what romance is. When you watch a great romance unfold on the screen, it makes your heart skip a beat because you are
all right, guys.
To triumph against all
no
odds.
Demon Slayer, no Jujutsu Kaisen, no One Piece, no Attack on Titan. Things. This is it. This is it.
Between characters, dialogue that makes us feel all the emotions, and what we all hope for. Okay, you guys, here's the nominees for best romance.
All right, some other shows have a chance, man.
最優秀ロマンス作品賞 Best Romance 堀宮 Peace 堀宮 The Missing Pieces
可愛い?
Horimiya was good. I didn't actually watch this spin-off series though. I've only seen the original one. I've only seen like, I think, one or two episodes. I would like Insomniac's After School to win.
You say no, Demon Slayer. Let's go! Remember, Tanjiro loves his sister very platonically.
Let's go! Sorry, totally missed that. Alright, I will say, I do prefer the manga of this one, but I love this romance, man. I love this romance.
My happy marriage.
If this is purely based on which one blew up the most or which IP is the strongest, it's probably this one. I think Yamada-kun is going to win. I think Yamada-kun is going to win it. I would like Insomniac's After School to win.
Oh.
Skip and Loafer, I watched it after my vid. I mean, Skip and Loafer didn't have the strongest romance.
Skip and Loafer.
I'm confused why it is, because this is like a great comfy slice of life. I wouldn't say it has like the strongest romance though, especially compared to other nominations. I was surprised that this took the spots over Dangers in My Heart. Because I was very surprised when Dangers in My Heart was not nominated for Best Romance last year. Alright, Yamada-kun's gonna take this one.
Goes to Horimiya Pieces.
Okay, I am wrong. Horimiya is still running on the same momentum that the original anime. Drink up, boy. I'll take it.
I'm speechless. There are so many wonderful pieces.
He said
we were chosen. So each one of staff created this piece. So everybody, actors, creators. We're able to make this wonderful masterpiece possible.
Bro, Roland stands out
in
so
my heart,
much compared to
Only
everyone.
Only My wins anime of the year, since Crunchyroll is anti-studio bind.
They're not anti-studio bind. Mushoku Tensei has been nominated. Wait a minute!
I'm from Birmingham in the
UK. Is that fucking Birmingham? Birmingham?
We should get mom this. She would love mom from a young age. I watched a lot of action and then like kind of mecha.
This
anime,
is
only,
this
like
is, if this is showcasing
stuff,
the positive
like,
things
oh,
about
I
Birmingham,
really
it'll be
guy,
the
like
only
the
video on the internet showcasing
so
the positive
cool.
things about Birmingham.
And,
man.
I'm actually an electrical engineer.
Oh, electrical engineer, let's go!
First job out of school, going into engineering at 16 as a nerdy black girl. It was hard.
Hell yeah. Triple E students, rise up, man.
Anime was definitely a big form of escapism for me. It was key for me to find characters who forged their own path and on the merit of their personality alone. Got to where they need.
Fucking
to
weird seeing Birmingham, I know, right?
And that really helped me to develop courage in myself.
Aww.
I started playing double bass in school. I would find like anime theme songs that I like, especially some of the ones from like the 90s, which are very instrument heavy. Sometimes the instruments are just going pretty crazy on those. So I'd play a lot by ear, or if I watched the Vocaloid concerts, I would listen to the bass players, listen to what they're doing. The song is nothing if not for the feeling it's carrying. Sometimes you want to throw a party, and if you want to throw a party, you do things that you enjoy, and I really enjoy playing anime music. If I'm gonna do a cosplay, I'm gonna choose a character that I love. I like to really express the characters I
Real
do
Birmingham bocce?
When I did this particular performance, there were young girls in the audience, young women who saw that and were like, you know what, yeah, I can be tough and I can take care of myself. But you don't realize the impact that you have by existing and living your life. I think I have become the person that I would have needed when I was younger. I think that's just divine and beautiful.
Wait, where's the YouTube chat?
This year, some of the most familiar and iconic anime series are celebrating major milestone anniversaries. The influential space battleship Yamato continues its adventures through space for going on 50 years now, and Gundam has created many series and has been loved by fans for 45 years.
It's been 40 years since the first Dragon Ball manga has been published.
And 40 years?
All over the world.
What?
And the Straw Hat Pirates of One Piece are still sailing the seven seas for 25 years.
And they will be.
Since the first
and they
anime
will.
Broadcast.
They always will be, man. They always will be. One Piece is never going to end.
About Brothers' journey and growth, the anime Full Metal Alchemist marked its
without
20th
Birmingham,
of
we wouldn't have Steve Handjobs, so it can't be all that bad. For even
one thank you for covering for me when Full Metal Alchemist was mentioned. Chatter donator. Thank you. Thank you. Thanks for covering for me.
We are tonight celebrating five of them.
Now we get to celebrate these momentous anniversaries with another orchestral performance.
Ooh.
With an arrangement by the wonderful Ryosuke Shigenaga and conducted by the incredible Yuki Tanaka, please enjoy an exclusive symphonic medley of
wait.
These iconic theme songs.
Yo, let's go! Did you hear Tanaka Yuki? You did. I have not watched Space Battle Yamato yet. Do it? It's like, it's... Isn't it old, though? It's old. People watch Jujutsu Kaisen and be like, wait a minute, you watched Madoka Magica? Isn't that old? You watched Haruhi? That's old, though. That's old. It's so good though. Yeah, I know. Recognize this song. Oh yeah, because it's Gundam. I was like, wait a minute, this ain't space. I recognize this song. And I was like, oh yeah, it's only the most famous mecha of all time. Okay. It's I know anime, guys. I know anime. Oh, the classic. Bringing out all the classics, man. For anyone not in like an English-speaking country, primarily, did you get Did you get this song as your Dragon Ball opening? Because for English dubs, we've got a completely different opening. I only know this song because of Team 4 Star. That's when I first heard the song. We got fucking Rock the Dragon, which is, I mean, that's my childhood, man. Yo, keep going. Pop off. Pop off, King. Oh, shit. Now we're talking, man. Oh. Can you imagine the last time you hear this on the last episode of One Piece? Oh, my God. If there is one request I have, is on the very last episode of One Piece, this is, you close off with this, man. You close off with this. I would not, I'm just crying, I want to cry just like thinking about that, man. Holy shit. I would cry so much. Holy shit. Yeah, in 20 years, yo, our kids are going to be watching this, man. My kid is going to be watching One Piece. This is probably my favorite performance so far, man. Oh, I'm getting so many feels from this performance, man. Oh. Oh my God. Even I know this song. Guys, what can I say, guys? I know this, man. What a banger song, man. Asian Kung Fu Generation, just like the OGs, man. No Naruto? I actually, do you know how I discovered this song? It was someone who edited this song onto like a Naruto opening. I was like, what fucking opening is this? This is back in like 2003 YouTube. That was beautiful. That deserves a clap, man. That deserves a clap. That's goddamn beautiful.
Coming up, an amazing performance by...
Yo! Let's fucking go! Alright, they may not have won the award, but I'll take it. I'll take it. Alright, I'm gonna go pee.
We drive innovation and creativity into new and exciting dimensions. Take, for example, the Gundam factory in Yokohama. The giant Gundam looks as if it has just stepped out of the world of anime. With cutting-edge technology, we're turning fan dreams into reality. What was once a figment of the imagination is brought to life through the power of technology and our passion for everything we create. Like Malaiken Studios Japan, we continue to inspire imaginations and open new worlds of possibility, combining technology and creativity to provide experiences unlike any the world has ever seen before.
Welcome back to the 2024 Crunchyroll Anime Awards, live from Tokyo. Here to present the award for Best Slice of Life are two anime lovers from two different sports worlds. Please welcome
Skip and Loafer. Skip and Loafer. This is it. Skip and Loafer.
DeMarcus Lawrence, and from Star Wars, The Mandalorian, and global pro wrestling superstar, Mercedes Varnado.
Skip and Loafer, Skip and Loafer. Sorry, Bocce fans. Slice of life, I gotta go Skip and Loafer, man. Although this is probably the only award Bocce has a chance of winning, or any of these anime have a chance of winning.
The slice of life category focuses on the things that happen every day. The quiet moments we experience with the people in our lives.
Professional wrestler?
It may seem like
God damn.
No action, and we may sometimes take this kindness of stillness for granted, but these small human moments are the things that shape us as people.
These anime have made the ordinary extraordinary, and we celebrate happiness, humor, and heartbreak with our nominees of Best Slice of Life.
All right, my bros, Bocce bros, I gotta betray you. I'm voting Skip and Loafer, but I don't think it's gonna win. Let's see who the nominations are. I can't remember the nominations. If Bocce wins, I ain't gonna be upset. I ain't gonna be upset. Alright, let's see who Bocce is up against. I don't think Do-It-Yourself is going to win against Bocce. Right now, I think who I predict is going to win is probably Bocce. Unless there is some show I'm forgetting.
Horimiya, peace.
No, Horimiya is not going to be Bocce, right? Horimiya is not going to be Bocce. Romance, I get it. I can understand. But slice of life? No, it's Bocce's still more powerful, right? Okay, Insomniacs After School. I mean, I prefer Insomniacs After School in the romance category, personally. If it didn't win romance, I have no hope for it winning slice of life.
Yamada-kun to level 999 no koi o suru. My love story with Yamada-kun at level 999.
Still Bocce. I still think Bocce has got this. Still think Bocce has got this.
Kyouka, ganbatte kudasai.
Yes! Let's go! Let's go! Skip and Loafer! Hell yeah! I'm the one fan, alright? Alright, Bocce's gonna win. And I'm not gonna be upset if Bocce wins, because Bocce also deserves. I would like Skip and Loafer, but I ain't gonna be upset if it's Bocce.
And the anime award goes to...
Give it to one of those two, please.
Bocce, The Rock!
Okay! My girl won something! Okay. We take those! We take those guys. Ah.
Bocce the Rock. In the beginning, well. In the beginning.
Jujutsu Kaisen robbed.
Mr. Miha said. He invited me to be involved, and I didn't think it'd become such a big thing to be receiving this award. It's really incredible. All the staff, everyone involved gave it their best for this piece.
Aww. Fuck yeah, man. Yo, he deserves it.
And we spent a year making this, and all of the fans who support us, I want to convey my deep gratitude.
Only a year?
Just thank you so much.
That show took only a year to make? What?
It's been a wonderful night. Let's keep this celebration going.
Hey,
let's
way ahead of you, man.
Best score. Hip hop artist, record producer, and activist, Shing O2.
Music is a vital part of any anime. When it's done well, it informs the mood, energy, pacing, and action of the story. The
right, all right. Score, what's best
an
score?
Emotional wave that you ride.
This is hard, actually. This is
so
hard.
To the final breathtaking conclusion, and these musical geniuses did just that. Here are the nominees for best score.
I think I voted Chainsaw Man for this one. I think Attack on Titan is going to win because of Sawano, and even though Sawano co-scored that.
Shingeki no Kyojin, the final season, Kankutsu-hen, Zenpen.
You think Jujutsu Kaisen is going to win? I don't think Jujutsu Kaisen... I mean, who did the Jujutsu Kaisen music? Normally, whoever wins this one, you know the composer by name. And the only composers people really know by name are like Hiroyuki Sawano. And Yuki Kajiro, right?
Butch the Rock.
Oh, how hype would it if Butch... Let me daydream for a second. How hype would it if would it be if Bocchi won, man? How hype would it be? guys, hear me out, guys. It's a music anime in an award show about best Chainsaw. Music, Chainsaw. Best score. Maybe there's a chance, guys. Guys, let me snort on that copium, man. Come on. It can be Chainsaw Man, Demon Slayer, Jujutsu Kaisen, Attack on Titan, right? Yo, what? They're showing this scene? What? Bruh! Yo, spoilers!
Oshinoko.
Man, they're showing all those scenes. Oh, Suzume? Oh, Jujutsu Kaisen didn't get nominated? Okay. Well, I would be surprised if it was close to this award. The only score I remember from this is hearing anime songs. Oh, shit. Attack on Titan's gonna win. Yes!
Final
okay,
season,
called it.
Final chapter special.
Called
one.
It. It was Attack on Titan, like I said. Like I said. Bocchi was second, clearly. Bocchi was second.
Thank you very much.
Oh, they're both there. Is that Kota Yamato?
The reason why we were awarded for this award is because Attack on Titan, the final season, the final chapters, season one. Director and sponsors and the people working for this show, they really deserve this award. I'm glad to have created the movie. It's such an honor to receive the award this year as well. So I'm so grateful for the piece.
Oh, it is the duo.
Started participating from season one.
Oh, shit.
Thank you for involving me in this award show. I'm really thankful to the fans of Attack on Titan Final Season. Thank you very much.
Bro, chat, you know, in order to live dub and live translate, you need to wait to hear what they say before you can translate that sentence, right? Of course, there's going to be a delay. Yo, he's trying his best, chat. He's trying his best.
Wonderful anime series.
Yo, it's not like they have their script.
She's also one of the stars of the new film, Lisa Frankenstein. Please welcome.
Yeah, this one is easy because they have the script. They know what they're gonna say. With the thanking, they're like, well, we gotta go off script, so I gotta actually listen to what they say.
Good evening, everyone. One of the things that truly excites me about anime is the incredible music. When you see that opening sequence, you hear that amazing theme song.
Is this best opening, or is this best anime song?
Totally immersed into the world. And then, as the end credits roll, music has the power to release a flood of emotions from what you just experienced. Then, you can go on with the rest of your day, safe in the knowledge that the hero triumphed over the dragon, or that your favorite couple fell in love. Music in anime plays a pivotal role, and these songs stand out as some of the best of the year. Here are the nominees for the best anime song.
All right, surely idol this time, guys. Surely, surely, surely idol this time. Surely, right, guys?
Idol, Yoasobi.
Surely.
Idol, Yoasobi, Oshinoko.
Banger, banger. Surely this one, Yoasobi is gonna get this one, surely. They didn't win Best OP, but Best Anime Song, surely?
Kickback, Yonetsu Kenshi, Chainsaw Man, Kickback.
I mean, Kickback is great song as well. Great song. Yo, I've never seen the music video to this before, man. Who won Best OP? Jujutsu Kaisen won Best OP. Okay, okay. If Bocchi wins, I'd actually be so hyped. But it's not going to win. It's not going to win, guys. It's not going... Bocchi Bros, come on, come on. Back to reality, Bocchi Bros. Back to reality. Come on, guys.
Suzume. Rad Wimps featuring
Believe Gun.
Rad Wimps featuring Toaka Suzume.
Oh, it's this song. Okay, the real question is there a Jujutsu Kaisen? Okay, there it is. Okay. Well, Bocchi fans, that is the nail in the coffin, okay? But Yoasobi fans, there's still hope. There's still hope, Yoasobi fans. There's still hope. There's still hope. It can beat the popularity because Idol was just... Oshinoko might have not been that popular, but Idol definitely was. Alright. I'm saying it. I'm calling it. It's Idol.
Parade. Sheena Ringo. Hell's Paradise.
It's the Yasobi Redemption Arc. Idol's gonna get this one. Idol's gonna get this one. All right.
And the anime award goes to Oshinoko.
Let's go! Yes! I believed! I fucking believed! I believed! Oh my god! They did it! Actually did it! Yo, now we're talking, man!
YOASOBI desu. Arigatou gozaimasu. Kono
yona subarashii. Thank you so much to be receiving such a great award.
I'm gonna drink to that. I'm a drink to that anyway, man. I'm a drink to that anyway.
Is made for Oshinoku and has spread around the world. So it's really like a treasure to us. Along with Oshinoku, you can all enjoy the song for a long time.
Oh, that's sweet. That's sweet. Man, imagine winning an award and then having to perform afterwards. That's gotta feel sweet, man. That's gotta feel so sweet. Imagine if they lost and they still have to perform, man.
Tengo un proyecto llamado Anime Dance en la que me dedico a bailar música japonesa por querer reflejar lo que el arte japonés ha inspirado en mí. Bueno, el anime.
All right, I have hope again, guys. I have hope.
Superación personal. Sea más creativo en algunos aspectos también.
Vinland Saga Season 2, I the hopium is continuing. The hopium is continuing.
Lo lindo de ese centro.
Jujutsu Kaisen beatable. Jujutsu Kaisen is beatable.
Literal, aquí se formaban las primeras comunidades de gente que le gusta el anime, la gente otaku. Me es importante acordarme de las máquinas de baile, del DDR, del Pump It Up, porque fue mi primer acercamiento con la danza. Yo de por sí no era una persona muy atlética, pero tener esa cercanía con música, anime, por el DDR. Mis metas a futuro es técnicamente seguir viviendo de la danza, pero me gustaría que fuera de la mano con Anime Dance. Veo una diferencia bastante clara entre los alumnos que yo tengo en otras escuelas de danza.
I'm surprised they didn't subtitle this part and the previous part as well.
Como es el gusto por la música
japonesa. Is this the global?
Si alguien quiere bailar música japonesa y ves que no lo hace muy bien, no importa.
Is this the global stream or is there a Spanish stream as well?
Mucha gente me decía que yo no iba a llegar a ningún lado con esto y mírenme ahora. Siempre he querido impactar en la gente con muchos de los animes y mangas que he leído han impactado en mí. Anime, o sea, es una inspiración constante.
Fuck yes! Yo, that goes so hard.
Coming up,
well-deserved best anime song of the year.
Megan Thee Stallion presents the award for Anime of the Year.
Oh shit, it's coming? It's coming? Anime of the Year, Megan? Megan Thee Stallion gets to do Anime of the Year? Oh, it's coming, guys. Are you ready? Are you ready? This might be toys and figures to video games. This might be the beer talking now, but I got a feeling, guys. I got a feeling. It's Vinland Saga. Worlds and characters. It's Vinland Saga. I got a feeling, guys. My hopium. I feel like at the beginning of the stream I was like, ain't no chance, but now I'm like, I'm feeling it, man. I'm feeling it. I think I'm feeling it, man.
Our work resonates with audiences across the world and throughout generations.
Come on, guys. Come on. Who's going to hope with me? Who's going to hope with me, guys? Who's going to hope with me? We need to pull a fucking Goku, man. I'm going to give Vinland Saga my power, man. I'm going to put my hands up, all right? Give me your power. I'm giving you the hope, man. I'm giving you the hope.
Welcome back.
The celebration continues. But before that, let's give another round of applause for Yo Asobi. Wow.
Wow. Awesome. Amazing.
And now, here to present the award for Best Film, from acting in the classic movie Kill Bill to singing the end theme for the famous anime series Mobile Suit Gundam Unicorn.
Amazing! He's the hype man, yo, he's the best hype man.
Chiaki Kuriyama.
Our best film is probably going to be Suzume, right?
But these next nominees for best film are the exceptions to the rule.
It's probably going to be Suzume, right?
Dazzling visuals, Slam Dunk was compelling and rich.
I don't feel like Slam Dunk was as well known worldwide.
Are just a few of the qualities that make these works truly outstanding.
I mean, Slam Dunk was massive here in Japan.
Here are the nominees for Best Film.
I feel like Shinkai's got this on name.
Best Film.
On just name power.
映画 Black Clover, 魔法帝の剣, Black Clover, Sword of the Wizard King.
Dune 2. Yo, that didn't even last year, man. L Black Clover, get the fuck out. Get out. We are a Black Clover loving family here. This is for Black Clover fans, man. I've heard this one was really, really good. I heard this was so good. I need to watch this one. It looks really good. I have not seen this one yet.
First kiss は終わらない. Kaguya-sama.
Was this good, Kaguya fans? Because I loved first season 3, but I didn't really hear anyone talk about the Kaguya-sama movie. Was this as good as season 3? Yes, it was good. All right.
劇場版 Psychopath Providence. Psychopaths, Providence.
I'm gonna be real, I didn't even know that there was a Psychopaths movie that came out.
Suzume no Tojimari. Suzume.
This is actually the only anime film I watched last year. I enjoyed it. I don't think it's Shinkai's best work, but I appreciate that he tried to do something new with it.
The first slam dunk.
I've also heard very, very good things about this. I still think it's going to be Suzume.
And the anime award.
Suzume no Tojimari desu. Yeah, there we go.
Suzume.
There we go. And there it is, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. I'll take it as the only one I actually watched out of all of them.
Congratulations.
I'm the director of Suzume. My name is Shinkai.
Oh, it's actually Shinkai!
I'm really, really, really happy.
the idol Yoasobi live. I'm just so shocked to see her perform.
Oh.
It was a great opportunity. The entire crew, I think, have a very difficult and long production period to make this anime.
He looks so young, I know, right?
I was on the world campaign with Crunchyroll.
Bro's fanboying. imagine winning an award and being like, yo, but how that performance though, really wasn't that so lit? Loved anime at Crunchyroll. Let's not talk about this award I'm winning. Let's talk about that fucking performance, man.
I'm quite moved by what Crunchy is doing. So having this wonderful experience and wonderful award, I'm just full of gratitude. Thank you very much.
He came to see Yoasobi, got a free award.
The next presenter is a 3-time Academy Award winning visionary director.
I mean, I just came to see the Yoasobi concert. This is nice extra as well.
Okja and the Oscar winner for Best Picture, Parasite, have left an indelible mark on global filmmaking. Let's welcome to the stage to present the award for Best Director, Bong Joon-ho.
Oh, shit. Yo, one director awarding another director.
Hey, 반갑습니다. 안녕하세요.
고맙습니다. 고맙습니다.
Thank you very much. Hello.
Yo, triple translation. Let's go.
불행히도 저는 토요일인데도 일을 하다가 왔어요.
今日は本当にいい土曜日なんですけど、もう残念ながら私は今日も仕事が終わりました。 This is a fantastic Saturday, but sadly, I was working earlier today.
Well, are we translating the translator now?
In my hotel room, I was working hard and drawing storyboards. In my hotel room.
This is going to be like you know when you put like those videos where you're like, I Google translated the script 10 times.
And actually, these storyboards are for an animation. I'm thinking about doing an animated piece in Japan. And here, there are so many of my wonderful predecessors and wonderful directors, so I'm quite nervous. Thank you for having me here.
Excuse me, he said Dai Senpai? I know what Senpai means. I've watched anime. You didn't need to translate that.
Today, I am honored to have this opportunity to announce a fantastic Japanese director. I'm very nervous. So now, let's see the nominees of Best Director.
Jujutsu Kaisen. That's going to win this one.
Best Director.
Jujutsu Kaisen is going to win this one.
Hayashi Yuichiro, Shingeki no Kyojin, The Final Season, Kanketsu-hen.
And I do think this is an award that Jujutsu Kaisen genuinely does deserve to be, you know, on the nominations.
Special one.
And does, I think, I can't remember the other ones, but this is one of those where I'm like, yeah, it genuinely does deserve it. Chainsaw Man deserves it as well. I really love the Chainsaw Man directing as well.
Saito Keiichiro.
So does Bocchi the Rock, but let's wake up, Frogs. Let's wake up.
Bocchi the Rock.
Let's wake up, guys. Bocchi ain't winning this one.
Bocchi-chan the Rock. Bocchi the Rock.
Oh, it's the Lord. She's. Yo, roll credits. It's done. Nakayama it's over. It's Chainsaw. Over.
Ryu Nakayama.
Pack it up, boys. Pack it up. Do you know my favorite edit of that? It's like Bocchi the Rock in 2004, and it's they play that over a Linkin Park track, and it just and it works so well. 2007. Sorry, yeah.
Hirotaka Mori. Heavenly Delusion.
I forgot that Heavenly Delusion got nominated for this. Heavenly Delusion also fantastic. Fantastic as well.
Goshozono Shota, Jujutsu Kaisen, Dai Niki. Shota Goshozono, Jujutsu Kaisen, Season 2.
Gojo-sensei.
Okita!
Chotto, sono isu takai yatsu desho?
Yobitsuke toite, inemuri shinai de kudasai yo.
I'm surprised they showed this scene in for Best Direction. There were so many well-directed scenes in. There were so many well-directed scenes in the first half of Jujutsu Kaisen. I'm surprised they just showed that one. I voted Chainsaw Man for this one. I genuinely hope Chainsaw Man wins this. But I think Jujutsu Kaisen is going to win, and I think that's almost equally deserved.
Anime
and the anime award
to.
Goes to. Shota Goshozono, Jujutsu Kaisen Season 2.
He deserves it. He deserves it, man.
Thank you very much.
Hell yeah. All right. All right. He's won me over.
I'm Goshozono. I didn't decide what to say up here. But you're anime makers, and you know how it is. And somehow we get through it. And I'm so happy that we have this recognition, so thank you very much. This is the Best Director Award. And I'm sure I have some talent, but there's such a large number of staff members. And it's really through them that I'm holding this award. So thank you very much, and my crew, for all your hard work. And thank you again. It's getting a little long, but thank you for this wonderful award.
Bro, what a wholesome guy, man. What a wholesome guy. That was protect him at all costs, man. Protect that man at all costs. He should have won. Should protect at all costs, man. He should have won it, not Anya.
She's a three-time Grammy Award winner, philanthropist, entrepreneur, and most importantly, an anime superfan. Please welcome the one, the only, Megan Thee Stallion.
It's time, boys. It's time. It's time. It is time. It is time for Vinland Saga Season 2 to get the recognition it deserves, guys.
I'm so excited.
Now okay. The MAPPA animators
First of all,
can know Peach KEKW.
To all of the honorees tonight. This was such an amazing year for anime, and it's a testament to the talented creators seated in this room tonight. And shout out to all the anime fans watching all around the world. I love that they get a chance to vote for these awards and we really get to find out what the fans are vibing to. Now, it is my honor to present Anime of the Year.
She got that Bucciarati drip, man. She got that JoJo drip. All right, all right.
Anime of the Year. Anime of the Year.
I like that fit, man. That's a damn good fit.
Bocce the Rock.
Okay, Bocce fans, come on, come on. You know this ain't got a chance. Come on. Come on, Bocce fans, come on. Give your hope to Vinland Saga. Come on, guys, give your hope to Vinland Saga. Come on. Come on, guys. Come on. Give your vote to Vinland Saga, man.
Chainsaw Man.
It's doing it. It's I believe.
Kimetsu no Yaiba, Katana Kaji no Sato Hen, Demon Slayer, Kimetsu no Yaiba.
The only one I care about. This is the only one I care about. Please, Vinland Saga Season 2. Please, 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 please. Come on, come on. No, come on, no Jujutsu Kaisen, come on. You got enough awards today. You got enough awards. Come on. It's time for Vinland. I have no enemies. Unless it doesn't win. Then I will have all the enemies.
Oshinoko.
Alright, here we go, boys. Here we go. Yes!
Season 2.
Let's go! Come on! I'm ready! I'm so ready for it to win, guys. It is going to win. This is going to age wonderfully. Just you watch, guys. Just you watch. Come on. Jujutsu Kaisen about to say, nah, I'd win. Nah, come on.
The award for anime of the year goes to Jujutsu Kaisen Season 2!
I just wanted one award for Vinland Saga, man. Oh, I had hope.
I have one enemy.
I had hope. I had so much hope. I mean, Vinland Saga. I mean, Jujutsu Kaisen was my third favorite anime last year.
I'm the producer.
If you saw my list, but
first off,
I'm just sad about Vinland Saga, man. Nah,
winning
this
award. You know, normally I think the director will come up for Anime of the Year. However,
I just the Hopium.
You received the best director awards, so I am
the Hopium. The Hopium has died. Back to reality.
Receiving this award is a huge honor. However, myself, since I've been young,
it's time to come back to reality, guys.
I have been watching pieces created by all the creators that are sitting before me.
Well, it didn't exactly completely sweep, but the only thing could really compete with it, I think the biggest
would be too much for me to do.
The biggest shocker of like which one beat it, probably Oshinoko. In terms of best anime song.
And contribute to this industry. I'll do my best. Thank you so much.
It's okay, guys. It's okay. We have no enemies, guys. We have no enemies. We have no enemies. We have no enemies, guys. Guys, we have no enemies.
Funny part is, next year's awards are all going to be JJK Season 2 Part 2 because of the season change law.
Thanks to everyone in this room, and to all the fans all around the globe. We'd like to sincerely thank our presenters, who we know wouldn't be here if they didn't have the same passion for the art of anime as all of us do.
Sally got through with it without having any contact lens issues this time. Let's fucking go, lads! Let's go!
And for that, we sincerely thank you.
Good night from Tokyo. Keep watching. I don't think I need to say this to you, but keep watching, keep loving anime, and we'll see you next year at the 2025 Crunchyroll Anime Awards.
Still to you. I love anime! Hell yeah! Alright, who's ready for next year when we get the Free Ren Awards? Right, guys? Not... Who's ready for next year, guys?
That's crazy, Onimai actually won. No way, totally not Copium.
Wasn't it great when... Wasn't it great me just getting, yeah. I've had enough beer. Been in Saga 1, right, guys? Next year?
And if eligible, Blue Eye Samurai will win at everything.
Blue Eye Samurai, I don't think is eligible. Pluto, I don't think. I mean, it would be cool if it won some awards. I think Free Run has the most chance of winning any awards. All I want is Free Run to win Best Fantasy. That's it. All right. Well, congratulations, Jujutsu Kaisen, on absolutely dominating these awards. I am surprised that Chainsaw Man didn't win anything, but I guess Jujutsu Kaisen was like, I think every nomination that Jujutsu Kaisen was win, that Chainsaw Man was in, Jujutsu Kaisen was also in. Recency bias? Yeah, I mean, Jujutsu Kaisen. Here's the thing, do you think Jujutsu Kaisen will still be as powerful without recency bias? That's going to be the big test, because next year Jujutsu Kaisen is still going to be eligible, but it is not going to be any more recent than it is now. All right. The stream is not going to end. I am going to be going through all of the awards for tonight and giving my full thoughts on each and every one of the winners, and not only my live reaction. So we're gonna stay live, guys. We're gonna stay live.
Did you see Yu-Gi-Oh! Anime card lore announcement?
I did not see the Yu-Gi-Oh! Card lore announcement. My Genshin streamer? Nah. I do not know what you are talking about. I don't know you. US gang, you can go to sleep now. If any of you guys are still awake, I really hope none of you guys are still awake. It's way too late now. It's way too late. It's far too late if you're in the US right now. All right. I'm wondering if this is it. Okay. Real weeb owls. We're in the real weeb hours now. I'm sorry, but gonna have one enemy every now and again is Jujutsu Kaisen fans. I mean, Jujutsu Kaisen fans are something else. Okay. Bro, I just got here. Bro, you missed. Bro missed the entire show. Bro just got here, bro. Bro be like, yo, when's the show starting? When's the show starting? I'm ready for the awards, man. I'm ready. When's the show starting? Alright, looks like there's no post show. Okay. Wondering if there is anything else. I'm wondering if they have they updated their website. Probably not. You never know. Anime awards. There we go. That's a rip. Come on then. Where's the where is all of the winner lists? So oops. Is that the actual Anime Awards website? Okay. So, okay. The awards has ended. Okay, well, that is the end of the Anime Awards. Thank you very much, Crunchyroll, for sponsoring me to watch the Anime Awards. Congratulations to all the winners. If you want a Crunchyroll account, you can click that pinned comment in the chat right now, or if you're watching on the VOD, just click that link in the description and get yourself a Crunchyroll account, and you can watch Jujutsu Kaisen on there.